Afternoon squad, morning, afternoon, evening, depends where you're from, obviously. Welcome back to Diamond Geezers 2. We're still going with this ridiculous adventure. We're back with yet another day. We've got the FA Cup third qualifying round today, which is going to be a massive game against Boston United, who we've already beaten this season, to be fair, so we should be able to give them a bloody good whacking. But we'll just see about that. The important thing about today is that we're well into season three. The squad is almost completely fit. For the first time this season, we've almost got a squad of players who are all actually capable of playing football, which is extremely exciting. I'll wait for a few more people to get into the chat, and then we'll get smashing right into this first game. We haven't got the FA Cup first. We've got Telford United first at the Dog and Duck, and then we go away to Boston United. A quick reminder that we have already been to Boston United once this season and thrashed them. 7-1, first game of the season. If I can, I'll be going for exactly the same team and exactly the same tactics. You can bet your bottom dollars. Oh, good morning, everybody, or good whatever it is. Colthia, good day from Australia. What time is it there? It must be at least midnight, I would say, or maybe 11 p.m. Depends where you are in Australia, I guess. Tim, welcome. Starbury, good morning on this very bittersweet day. Yeah, I know. Birchie, boo. Good morning, lads. Good morning. Yeah, I know. It's a bit of a weird day. Los Colderos is not... Los Colderos isn't over, is it? It can't be. I've had too much shit online for it to be over. I don't really want it to be over, to be honest. I just need to have a break. I actually... When I wrote my tweet yesterday that said I need to take a break after the Champions League final, it was immediately after I'd actually played the game. I just finished the penalties, the shootout. And it was brutal. I sat like this, just looking at my screen for about 5 minutes. Tim, no spoilers. I just couldn't believe what had happened. Well, there was a penalty shootout, but at the end of it, I just sat like this, and I didn't know what to do with myself. I just didn't know what to do. So, I mean, it's all wide open what to do next, really. There's lots of... But I mean, the Champions League final, whichever way it goes, whichever way it went, was always going to be a good place to finish, for a while. I just need to take a break from Los Colorados. Not only does it take up so much time, but getting that far into a competition is genuinely tiring. It's genuinely exhausting because there's so much riding on it. So anyway, I'm gonna take a little break, maybe for a couple of weeks, and try and figure out what to do. Good morning, everybody. Ah, oh, everybody's in the chat. What a bunch of lads. Germ Ridden, Santos, Martin. Oh, 10 p.m. coffee. You're nice. Tim, sorry if I don't. Hopefully, I don't know. I maybe just spoiled the result. I don't know. NJ, DMAC, Colmanizer. Cheers, lads, for coming back. DMAC. What? I'll do something next, regardless. You know, I'll either, Tim, unfortunately, it's going to be impossible for you to avoid spoilers because people are going to talk about it in the chat. So, sorry, you might just need to go read it. NJ, thank you for saying that. That means that I must have written it reasonably well. But yeah, RVX, good afternoon. Tim, good idea. So there'll be something next. It's just a case of what. I'll either leave and go to a new club in the same save, which somebody suggested in the chat, and I said I didn't want to do that. But having thought about it, I forget who it was, so shout yourself out if it was you that suggested that. I might actually go back and return to that idea. Steve Gustan needs to come out. That's okay. Bernardo can go. Because I do quite like the idea of at least seeing how they get on, whether it's with me in charge or whether it's with somebody else. So I'll make a decision about it at some point, but I just need to just recharge. And I just, to be honest, is you know, like when you play Champ Manager and you have a result, whether it's a good one or a bad one, and you afterwards you just sort of feel like that I need to, that's it. I don't want to play this anymore. I think that's the feeling. One way or another, you either feel like you finished it, or you just feel like the result is so devastating that I just can't. I don't want to play this anymore. And that's kind of how I feel. I think I need to take a couple of weeks off. Yeah, exactly. Miguel Pablo needs a year in rehab or under house arrest. Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, I need to go to therapy. I think I just need a couple of weeks off of just not thinking about Los Colorados, so that I suddenly go, oh, I wonder if I should, and then I feel a little bit more re-energized. But I just need to have a little break from it because it's been, 9 months of solid writing on that series, pretty much. It was July, August time that I started writing it. It's now April, middle of April, so it's solid. It's been a lot. But anyway, enough of that. We're not here to talk about that. We're here to talk about this. First game of the day, AFC Telford. I just realised I haven't brought any water in, so my mouth is going to go very dry very quickly. So I'm probably going to have to go and get some water in a minute. But this is a league game. Oh, look at their fun formation. Two defensive midfielders. They see us coming. Telford have prepared for us. It is true as you go through the leagues on this that other teams definitely do start to plan for you, but I'm not going to worry about them too much. Estevez with the instructions. We might not need to set my wingers. Let's have a quick look. Oh no, yeah, I definitely do. Right back. Oh, left back. Okay, Alonso was on the right guy. I think we're looking pretty good. Let's do this. Go out there and impress me. They never care about that. Let's have another go for it. I have faith in you. How about there's no pressure on you? Yeah, there we go. That's the one. Yeah, relax them. Just get them nice and relaxed. Make a difference, man from Belmonte. Oh, we're on counter. Need to change that. Let's do it. Oh, got it up pretty loud. Right. Here we go. First game of the day. AFC Rushden, AFC Telford. The battle of the AFCs. The AFC Derby, you might call it. Pretty boring opening 10 minutes. Need to set us to control. Control's the way forward, literally. Oh, Colthia, I read it on my phone, scrolling one line at a time. Yeah, I tried to write it. I wrote it with that in mind. Oh, Ajnani's in. Oh, good challenge. Good challenge. Oh, yeah. Oh, Tim, don't worry, mate. Thank you for reading it and then coming back. It's very kind of you. Yeah, it was brutal, man. It was brutal. It was brutal. I need to just sleep it off for a few weeks. Oh, Rosso's in there. Yes, great first goal. Rosso's done really well there. Just elbowed his way into the box. Finished with aplomb. Let's take another look at that. Nice corner in from Ajnani. Rosso makes the move. Newton takes a flying dive. Rosso's like, get up, mate. Oh, hang on a minute. Bosh. 1-0. 1-0 AFC Rushden. If anyone's drinking today, get it on. Get it on. Oh, Luke. Welcome. Welcome. Welcome back. Oh, Chucklebury. Welcome back. Welcome back. Thanks for coming, you guys. Oh, the big stud man. Oh, just over him, Alonso. It's been a good start to this game, to this stream. I mean, like last season, we decided once we had an unassailable lead at the top of the table, you guys said that I should just go and basically finish the league by myself and come back once we've won it. At what point do we do that in this division? Because if this carries on, this trend that we've got to win, this unfamiliar trend we've got towards winning games constantly. Oh, that was unlucky. Oh, Alonso's in. Oh, unlucky. Unlucky. Their defenders have just got no idea what to do with us. At what point do I just take over and just finish the season? Because we're just bossing it. I mean, I guess with the FA Cup, we'll have to keep coming back until we get knocked out of the FA Cup at least. But if we're just ploughing through the Blue Square North. Oh, Ajnani. I feel like this run can't possibly last. But at the same time, who's going to stop us, really? I mean, who's going to stop us? Oh, Stephen with a PH, not ready yet. Oh, Albrechtsen. Oh, it's oh. There's quite a lot of chat about it, Stephen with a PH. So I would maybe recommend having it on in the back, like having a read of it while we're on in the background or something. Just because I wouldn't want you to get spoiled like Tim was. Tim got spoiled immediately in the chat. Oh, just lovely. And the players are just so... all they can do is take us out. They've got nothing, AFC Telford. Nothing. Oh, that was a great ball in. Yeah, it's a pretty bad pitch, isn't it? But like I said, we can't request that we get the pitch relayed because it's not our ground. And I don't think there's an option to request that Wellingborough do it. Oh, that's a good ball in as well. Oh, Rosso at the back post. Nearly got his second goal of the game. Great save. Asnani in again. Oh, Albrechtsen. Does a bit too much chesting down for my liking. Oh, Busby, where's he going? Nowhere. I wonder if it's worth taking the defender that... So Albrechtsen's on near post flick on, right? I feel like sometimes he just kind of gets in the way of Rosso. I wonder if it's worth taking him off, just having nobody on near post flick on. Oh, that's a good ball in too. Just have nobody on near post flick on so that the person that's on the guy that's on attack near post just has a free run at it. Maybe that's... We'll try that second half. Good half, though. Good half. We're all over them. I might just try that second half just to see if it makes any difference. Just have Albrechtsen on... Well, we'll just have him on go forward. So the only person that's near post is Rosso on attack near post. We'll just see if that... I'm just curious. Because I think sometimes the ball's curling in towards Rosso and Albrechtsen comes off the post and, like, chests it away from him, which just makes no sense at all. So we'll just give that a go and see if it makes a difference. We don't score as many goals from corners as I'd like, you see. Oh, Belmonte can't get there. Oh, I wasn't really looking. I was trying to keep up with the chat. That was a pretty good finish. I've obviously spoken way too soon about us being unstoppable in the league. The moment I mention it. Let's have a look at this goal again. Defenders. What is Albrechtsen doing? There's a couple of people out of position there. That's a good finish. That is a good finish. But Belmonte's not really in a good position. Albrechtsen's way out of position. Oh, stud. Oh, stud. Oh, so close from the stud. So close. Panzer's only on 6.1 as well. That's a bit disappointing. Come on. Yeah, Rosso. Oh, Rosso. Completely clear. I'm going to say that that's worked. I'm going to go ahead and say that that worked. Great header. There's just, see, Rosso's just got, as long as Rosso can get away from his marker, which he does with ease, since the marker's just standing still, he's got a completely clear header. I reckon that's the way to go. We'll see. They do have three central midfielders, which is overloading us a little bit. Oh, great blocks. Oh, great defending. Great defending to force him off target. Superb. How are you doing? Vincenzo Bernardo hasn't really offered a lot. He comes back very slowly from injury. I'm going to take Bernardo off. Stick Sosa. Oh, why is it being so slow? Oh, hang on. Bernardo's just put a cross in there. Oh, headed away. Okay. Deep line forward. It's being really slow. What's going on? Really sluggish. Oh, Busby's tired as well. Oh, I haven't really got a midfielder on the bench. I've stuffed that right up. God, it's being really weird. What's going on? Let's just get rid of that. Maybe that's the reason. Okay. I mean, they have just had the one shot on target, Telford. Oh, that's a good ball. Oh, Bernardo, I've just taken him off because he wasn't doing anything. Immediately rips a net buster into the top of the net, into the roof of the net. Classic. Honestly, I think that I should just keep saying things because whatever I say, the opposite immediately happens. So I was just saying that Bernardo wasn't really doing anything and that he comes back from injury slowly and he just immediately rips a goal into the roof of the net. Ridiculous. Right, let's have a check on the chat. Haven't been looking at it for a while. Oh, Max, thank you so much. Thank you, Max Power. That's really kind of you. Thank you, I appreciate it. Yeah, Clayplay, you brought in a load of youth players. We want to see them blooded at the end of the season. Yeah, so, yeah, I'll definitely at least do that. That's flicked just wide. Oh, Phylum, welcome. Thanks for coming back. Got to be proud of where you took it. Feel like M. Pablo has another job somewhere else in this save. Yeah, that's kind of what I'm thinking as well. Oh no, who was that got injured? Oh, Adjinani. It's okay. Adjinani, just constant injuries. Adjinani is the new Omar for injuries, that's for sure. If it was a documentary, the final kick would be a black screen, crowd reaction. Yeah. Yeah, Kelfia, yeah. And that's pretty much it. You've more or less hit the nail on the head with that. That's terrible. But yeah, I think Alcoholics Anonymous is going to get a new member for a few weeks. It was really tough. It was just so stressful. Every single thing about that game, was so stressful. So yeah, what a goal. Yeah, it was a great goal, that. Oh, there's Rosso again. Oh, so close. Yeah, I think the single man on the near post is potentially the way to go. I think it's worked so far. It's just a case of which one it is. Rosso definitely staking a claim. I think that's like his fourth goal of the season he's scored. Come on, lads. Let's just keep it. Just keep him out. Not long to go. That's fine. It's fine with the man in goal. That would have gone in with Gilps. 100%. Oh, what a... Oh! Did you see that? That was disgraceful from the Panzer. Oh, my God. If that had gone in... Oh, that would have been the... That would have been not just goal of the season. That would have been goal of the decade if that had gone in. Hang on a minute. We need to spin this back. This is disgraceful what he does here. Let's get right in there. Did you see that? He did the stud flick, and it nearly went in. Watch Panzer. He does the stud flick. Look at that! It's absolutely outrageous, and it hits the bar. Oh my God! Honestly, this game sometimes. My players are unbelievable. I love them so much. Is it main stage? Yeah. Crazy. That is just crazy. We're just showboating this whole league. Rosso man of the match. We scored two from centre half. Very good. Yeah, DMAC, I did a similar thing on Champ. Resigned after taking the club as far as I could. The board appointed Mark Hughes and he butchered my side. Yeah, ended up regretting leaving. Los Colaleros creates so many chances. Big Ron will score at least 40 goals next year. Yeah, that would have been... I would have done a shot if that had gone in. That cross or cross shot from the Panzer. Just disgraceful. Yeah, Ross has got 4 goals this season. Right? I'm going to have to change that. I have to change my throw-ins to just short. The long ones just do not work. Take all my throw-in takers off. And then we'll go set-piece creator. Attacking corners. Albrechtsen can just be go forward. Yeah, can just be go. In fact, you know what? No, actually, you know what? Albrechtsen can stay back. Because the thing is that... Oh, that's defending corners. Whoops, that's defending corners. Albrechtsen can stay back because if he's not going to be in the box, he's not going to add much. And the main danger from corners is getting caught on the counter. So yeah, I'll just tell him to stay back. Rosso can just do all of our... Rosso can be our goal scoring defender. We'll try and get Rosso to 10 goals this season. Looks pretty good. I mean, it's only the middle of October and he's already got 4. Yeah, NJ, I've always found the job offers on Champ to be very disheartening. I agree that they just don't appear. They just don't arrive in with the regularity that you would expect. Bertie, that sounds like a shocking morning. Glad thanks for being with us while you're or afternoon. Thanks for being with us while you're doing horrendous household chores. I'm glad that we can keep you amused. Oh, I've got a bug bite. That's annoying. Oh, right. Okay, that was a good win. And now we've got Boston United away in the first round. No, not the first round. What were the third qualifying round, sorry, of the FA Cup. Depending on how quickly they come together, the games, we should be able to play the third and fourth qualifier. Assuming that we beat Boston United, we should be able to get to the first round FA Cup draw, assuming that we get that far. I've no idea who we'll have in the last game, but really, we can't fear anybody at this point, surely. Even a team from the Blue Square Premier, I wouldn't fear. Be all over them, I reckon. At the end of today's stream, guys, I'm going to raid Dr. Benji FM, if that's all right with all of you. Dr. Benji's streams are awesome. I've been watching his streams recently and his follow-up videos. He's so good at this. This the whole He's so good at the streaming. He's been really successful. He totally deserves it. He's been doing it for years. He's a bit of a role model for me for this, 100%. He's done such a great job. And yeah, I'd like to start raiding his channel, and I've got him on auto host. Oh, check this out, right? This is something that I did over the weekend. Look at who I found on a free transfer. Salif Diao. Can play right back or right wing. Hasn't got any caps for Senegal yet, but no matter. Dutch second nationality. Got him in on trial. See what he looks like, because my scouts couldn't get a report on him because we can only do players that are based in the UK and Ireland. But Salif Diao, everyone, could get Salif Diao in. Could be a signing. Bertie, we're going to Wembley, exactly, yeah. Oh, is it Wembley on this, or are we still going to the Millennium Stadium? I think it must be Wembley by now, mustn't it? Clayplay, bring him in. Yes, agreed. Agreed. Oh, Stephen, yeah, I'm sorry, mate. I'm sorry, it's tough, isn't it? It's rough. The old Wet Bandits is very tough. Yeah. I think at the moment, what I'm thinking is I'll take a little bit of time off. I'll do one more season with them, but I'll do a sh much shortened version of the season. So I'll just play a season and I'll maybe do like a two-part episode that covers the entire season, is what I think. Or maybe three parts. I'll just see how it goes. But I can't do another really in-depth season because as much as anything else, I haven't got time. But I'll maybe do a shortened version, and then at the end of that season, we'll see who's available. Oh, Salif Diao. Oh, that's as a right. Hang on a minute. Right back. Okay, so he'd be our second best right back, and our second best right winger. Boom. Oh, Salif, you legend. Let's get him on a longer term contract. I've made huge mistakes with not getting players on long term contracts. A lot of them didn't want them, you see. No, come on, come in for longer. Just take at least 500k as a release clause. Oh, no. Okay, how about that? Yeah. 160k would be all right, and we'll negotiate him out of that later. Carr had already said he was going to retire. Don't know why he's re announcing it again. Attention seeker. NJ, yeah, my haircut tweet. Yeah, thanks. It's getting a little bit out of control. Though actually now at this point it's gotten to be so long that it's starting to, actually form into a hairstyle again. Oh, NJ, I recently broke down and let my wife cut my hair. How did it go? How did it go? Please tweet us the results. Okay, right. Okay. As Nani's, we know that he's crocked. Bernardo's still coming back from injury. Oh, Ake needs a rest. Well, Ake can have a rest later. Who's back? Full. We're overstocked in central midfield, so that's good. Okay, let's see. Steve Gustan can come in the centre. Omar can come in on the side. Swap with Alonso. There we go. Panzer, despite that flick, can come out, and the child can go in at left back. What's his PR all about? Oh, he wants high win bonuses. Yeah, everyone's delighted with their high win bonuses. Estevez can go on the bench as sub 4. I feel like playing Sosa, to be honest. No, we'll leave. Actually, yeah, we'll give Sosa a run instead of the stud. Love the stud. I think he's our top scorer, isn't he, this season? He's still just, yeah, 11 and 12, just absolutely running away with it. But I like the way Sosa stretches defences, and the stud has also he's scored at least four of his goals off the bench. Capolino's still out. It's disappointing. Got a lot of injuries. Fulton can come back into the team. Yeah, he can come back in for Marv. As much as I love Marveggio, he could do with a rest. So we'll give Fulton a game. A lot of my players are wanted, which is troubling to me. Limerick want Fulton. Calais Rugby Union Football Club. I wouldn't go and play there, Steve. It's the wrong sport. Who wants Sosa? Notarina? Well, yeah, we've got a lot of wanted. Okay, so. We're doing okay. Actually, you know what? We'll put Bernardo on the bench because I think he needs. Oh no, he's back to being match fit. Still only 76% though. And we'll keep Rago on the bench because Ake's going to have to come off at some point, I think. Yeah, that looks pretty good to me. Oh, Sooty's voice only just recovered from Saturday. Yeah, I know. Oh, seven subs. Yeah, you're quite right, Clayplay. Good spot. Seven subs. Okay, we'll put Estevez on the bench then. And we could do Jess definitely do with another defender. Which one? Panzer. I might put Enrique on. Oh no, we'll put Johnny Fortune on the bench. Yeah, we'll put John Fortune because our Albrechtsen can play either fullback, I think. If we, oh, I can play right back. Okay. In that case, we'll take Ragu off the bench, and we'll put the Panzer on because that's the back four covered. There we go. Good spot. Thank you. Good job. Chuckleberry Lynn, you should see my hair. We'd love to see your hair. Give us a photo. Oh, that's good, NJ. That's cool. That's cool. Oh, Sooty just read Collaveros. Yeah, welcome. Sorry, this is the support group officially. This today's stream is a support group. Well, we're also going in to play Boston United. So remember, everybody, that we beat Boston United on the first day of the season 7-1. That obviously isn't going to happen again. There's just no way, he said, because every time I say something won't happen, it does. But that isn't going to happen again. But hopefully, we'll just tell everybody that we're underdogs, even though I don't really see how that's possible. Oh, Alonso's on the right man. Omar is not. There we go. Right. FA Cup, third qualifying round, Boston United, AFC Rushden. We've already wiped the floor with them once this season, so hopefully we can just get out there and do it again. The thing is that was the first game of the season. Once you're 5 or 10 games in, oh my God, they really should have just gone 1-0 up. Once you're a few games into the season, everything's different. Yeah, we all know that the first day of the season brings up some wild results, as some teams are more fit than others, they're more prepared, you know. So that first game of the season, that's got to be a write-off. I don't really see that. Feel like we can hang anything onto that. Oh, Alonso, there was a ball in. Sosa's nearly made it. Get there, Alonso. He has. Oh, he's put it wide. Oh, Alonso had an open goal. But from a tight angle, and he's put it wide. It's a little bit slow, isn't it? I need to change that. Oh, Alonso! Oh, just over. Put the speed down a bit too low. Yeah, everyone wants your players. This is the game penalising you. Yeah, it's, you know, we're too successful. That's the problem. We're just too good. Ake's kind of done well by accident. Steve Gustan with his dribbles. Remember, Steve Gustan's got like eight dribbles per game, which is just ridiculous. Ridiculous. Come on, let's see if this works. Let's get the tactics out. Come on, Rosso, get there. He's basically unmarked at the moment. Oh, he's there! Rosso! It totally works. It totally works. Rosso's fifth goal of the season. Yep, there you go. If anybody's about to play FM12 or already playing it, there's a tweak to your near post tactic. Take the near post flick on player out and just have somebody on attack near post. Rosso, in the last two games, has got to, since I took Albrechtsen away, he's got to virtually every one of them. Boston are in our division, Max. We're in the same league. We've already played them this season in the league. We beat them 7-1, first day of the season. So it's in a way, you could, I mean, it's a good draw, really. We could have had a better draw. Oh, because there were teams in the draw that don't even have a division. They're even below the regional divisions, regional first divisions. So we missed all of the really easy games. Oh no. Oh, I thought that was Omar going down. Go on, lads. Yes, keep going. Don't stop. Don't stop. Yes. Sosa, play it. Oh, that's a great ball through for Omar. Make it two. Omar Karoma makes it two. Boston United won't be happy because they've got a man on the deck. We couldn't care less. Boston nil, AFC Rushden two. Fourth qualifying round, here we come. I really hope we get another decent draw. I really want to be in the FA Cup first round proper. Can you imagine? I really hope we don't. I bet we get the team top of the Blue Square Premier away in the next round, assuming that we win. But we've made a very good start. Oh, Steve Gustans had taken a hit. He might have to come off. That's okay. We've got the bench. We've got the bench to cope with it. Oh, my goodness. Yeah, five already for a defender. Yeah, that's right. Yeah, he's been really good from corners. And now that I've taken Albrechtsen, I realised Albrechtsen was just getting in his way. Because the other thing about having a player on near post flick on is that another defender is there too to mark him. So by taking Albrechtsen off the near post, you actually take two players away from the near post. And as long as Rosso can get away from his man, which he seems to do every time, he's got a free header or free volley or whatever at goal. I'm even tempted to take Rosso off near post and put one of my put my striker there. Because surely you want your most dangerous striker. But actually, you know, Rosso's already got five. So let's just let him do what he's doing. Oh, go on, Sosa. Oh, that's a good tackle. Oh, Gustan. Whoa, what a hit. Swerving hit from the edge of the box. Yeah, that's Omar's finish, I guess, Max. Yeah, very cool finish. Great first half. I'm going to take Steve Gustan off. Give Bernardo a chance to get his match fitness back to full. Yep, keep it up, lads. Let's keep going. Absolutely do them. I realised from watching my highlights videos after I edited them that I do a lot of clapping. But it's because the team are playing so well, all you can do is just sit back and applaud. It's just so good. Go on, Busby. Yes, Omar. Yes. Oh, he squared it. Bernardo. Oh, Bernardo hits an absolute thunderbolt. Blocked. Unlucky. That was travelling. Go on, the man. Oh. I just can't believe how good we are. Yep. I know. I just shouldn't speak. I'm just cursing my own speech patterns, which can just conspire to stitch us up at every turn. Go wide. Yeah. Oh, lovely one touch. Oh, Bernardo. Oh, Bernardo. That was so good. Just skinned his man. I'm going to take Ake off. Put Fortune on. Albrechtsen can go right back and just defend. Should be fine. That's another thing I need to do, actually, is I need to take little Ricky. Oh, no, Johnny. Oh, mate, what is wrong with you? Oh, dear, Johnny Fortune's injured. It's going to have to be Panzer, but it's not great. Oh, wait, what did I just do? Took off the wrong person, yes. Panzer 4, where's he gone? Fortune, what am I doing? All right, we're going to have to just put Panzer right back. And just hope that he does okay out there. See how it gets on. Should be fine. Rosso. Oh, Rosso. I thought he was going to go overhead kick. Oh, Panzer nearly scores. Nearly scores from the corner. Not quite. Oh, Omar. Oh. It's a shame you can't do inverted wing backs on this one. Oh, that's a lovely ball. Alonso, oh, mate, just wide. Really should be 3-0 by now. Yeah, it's, on one of the later FMs, you can do inverted wing backs for your wing backs. And it's great for when you've got somebody who's on their wrong foot, like Panzer is. I would definitely have one inverted wing back if I had the option. Oh, you know the other thing, lads. Oh, Rousseau. Oh, he's just tackled on the line. The other thing is that I don't know if you guys saw on Twitter, but I did start the GoFundMe for AFC Rushden. I started a GoFundMe for their sponsorship. Oh, great save. Great clearance. So if you go to my Twitter account, twitter.com/MikePaulVox, the pinned tweet at the top of my page is a link to the GoFundMe page for the shirt sponsorship for AFC Rushden. So I forget who suggested it in the last stream, but I spoke to Ralphie B. He said it was fine. So I've set it up. We've made a start. I mean, Rousseau. Oh, Rousseau, another chance. We've made a start, but it's been a fairly weak start considering that we're trying to raise £18,000. But we got a few hundred off to kick it off. So if anybody wanted to contribute to that, the GoFundMe exists now, so you can find that. You can also just go to GoFundMe.com and just search for AFC Rushden, and it'll be there. Jonathan Misfortune, thanks Clayplay. Thanks for coming, mate. We should write all these down and do a stand-up special at the end of the stream. Between you and Phil My Funyuns, we've got so much material. Great tackle, Panzer. Yes, this one's surely over. Surely. Good headers away. Oh, the man, what a save. Yes. A second win of the season at York Street. Boston 0, AFC Rushden 2. Boom. FA Cup fourth qualifying round. Here we come. Magnificent is what I'm going to say. Okay, there we go. So, who will it be next is the question. Who will we get next? I don't know if the fourth qualifying round is where the Premier teams come in, the Blue Square Premier teams. I've got no idea how the qualifying rounds of the FA Cup work. I know that there are four of them, so the next one is the last one before the proper first round. But I guess we're about to find out. Oh, yes. And we get prize money for every game we win. How's the money situation doing? Oh, we are losing quite a lot of money, aren't we? But it's all this garbage here. 13 grand a month to this ridiculous loan. Okay. Oh, no, Fortune. Oh, Fortune is gone. He is long gone. 2 to 3 months at a specialist. Definitely sending him to one. That is bad for Johnny Fortune. That could spell the end of his top-level career. It may be time to pull one of my young centre-backs up from the reserves. Who's got the best ability? Well, Jonathan Fortune, other than him. Jamie McCormack. Actually, you know what? Let's include my under-18s as well, just in case. So, based on ability, it's probably the same guy. Oh, no, it's Bradley Donaldson. 1 star, 2.5 star potential. But we also got McCormack. Can you... Oh, yeah, you can. You can filter by centre-back. So, who's got the best potential? Kian, but he's really a fullback, so we'll leave him out. So we've got a few players that have got 1 star, but Kellen Daly has got 1 star ability, but then he's got the best potential, supposedly. Liverpool, former Liverpool youth player, then went through Blackburn and now he's here. Aggression 16, that's all I need to see. Kellen Daly comes up to the senior team to replace Jonathan Fortune, probably for the rest of the season, if we're being completely honest, because Johnny Fortune, he keeps breaking down either in training or in games. So, yeah, DMAC, it is the Jonathan Fortune glue factory. Yeah, well, Jonathan Fortune's a coach. I signed him as a player coach because really I just wanted him for his coaching attributes, but he also was still a handy player. So he was only ever meant to be a reserve. But in the summer, I really struggled to find good centre-backs. And from the centre-backs I signed, he was still in the top four for ability, so that's why I left him in. Birchie, I think they do, yeah. Do they realise potential faster if they play first team? It definitely helps their development. Riquelme's going to retire. Shame. Big, big shame. Oh, well. Yeah, so my coaches are constantly telling me that Melvin has developed more because he's had exposure to first team football. So they do say that. So yeah, that's why rather than trying to sign a new defender, now that I've got all of these young players that have got decent potential. I don't know, obviously, I don't know what their potential actually is. I've got to trust my coaches. But 3.5-star potential, if he was to live up to that, he'd be my best defender. So he might as well be in the team. And actually, with Jonathan Fortune gone, he is my joy. I mean, these two aren't centre-backs, so they don't count. He is actually my fourth best defender. We might have a look for another centre-back in the transfers, but to be honest, I'm happy with Rosso and Albrechtsen, so I wouldn't want to sign somebody on like massive wages who would demand a first team place to replace one of those two, because they're doing fine. So I like the idea of pulling the kids into the first team. He's a tampon, in for 1 week, out for three. My goodness, there's a lot of this which I don't know if I'm happy with this. I think I have to be happy because the board keep just injecting money into the club to keep it running. But it's not like we're really close to zero. You know, we've got a lot of money in the bank. They probably don't need to keep doing it, but I'm just gonna keep quiet. Right, here we go. Here we go. Oh no, yeah, here we go. Aldershot are in. They're a Blue Square Premier team. Yeah, I really hope we don't get Aldershot, because I used to play for them. So I don't want to play teams that I love. Okay. I would do automatic draw, but it's going to take forever. So we're just going to go draw all teams. Oh, we haven't got Aldershot. Oh, we're away to Bury Town, who are in the Isthmian Premier. So they are a division below us, or a level below us, I should say, in the Isthmian Premier League. How are they doing? Where are they? Bury Town, sixth in the Isthmian Premier. It's a good draw. That is a good draw. It could have been a lot worse. We could have ended up with a really good Blue Square Premier team. If we'd got Crewe or Aldershot, I'd be pretty sick. Because my draws in the cup are almost always away. You'll know it from those of you that have read Diamond Geezers and Los Coladeros. You know that I always get away draws in cups, and I don't know what it is. I would say probably 3/4 of all the cup draws I've ever got have been away. So that's good. Bury Town. Bury Town is a good draw. You know, something I miss from the newer FMs is the star players that you get in Champ Manager, where it highlights their three best players as their star players. Oh, I've got one of their defenders on my shortlist. Yeah, DMAC, he was part of the Young Fish Cost a Fortune back four. He was, because I think Martin said something about that in a previous chat. Bury is where my mum lives. Play at Ram Meadow. A guy I went to school with managed them for a bit. Really, DMAC? Is there a Carl Deeks there? I'll have a look. Sorry, I pressed continue before I saw your chat. I'll have a look in a sec. Carl Deeks. That's a game we should be able to win. I'm not going to put my kids out, though. It's tempting to play, you know, a sort of young, up-and-coming team against the side that are below you in the structure, but no. I want his strongest team every time for the FA Cup. I'd rather rest players in the league, to be honest, considering the lead we've got. I haven't checked the table, actually, but we must be... We were at least 6 points. We were 9 points clear after the last stream, so we must still be at least 9 points clear. Oh, CM Ted, good morning. Good morning, mate. Good to see you again. Thanks for coming back. Oh, mate, Chucklebury, my cousin was selected for Bury Youth. He threw up after a really hard training session and they dropped him. Wow, that's amazing. That's amazing. I threw up after training sessions before and have been praised because they associate it with hard work. But what do I know? What do I know? Yeah. I also had a coach in Edinburgh tell me that he was going to break my jaw so that I could only drink through a straw for a month so that I lost some weight. So what do they know? What do they know? Look at me now. What did he know? Play the first team, make mincemeat of them. Yeah, I think I considering the way that the league is going, so far, the cup is actually more of a priority, especially because the cup gives us prize money as we go, and it gives us more prize money than winning the league does. So financially and in terms of just brilliant fun, we definitely have to. Uh-oh. Oh, he keeps saying that Henk de Jong is improving. His attributes are going up, but yeah, my opinion of him is not, unfortunately for him. Oh, I love the team of the week. I love that we've got this now. We're into real leagues. Oh, Hadzi Mehmedovic left his agent. Okay. Yes. Sure. No. Get out of here. Right. Feeling pretty good. Hopefully, we'll get Salif Jow in soon. He would be a good signing. Nice, good, versatile. He's also a player we've all heard of, presumably. Former Stoke City. I don't remember him being a right back or a right midfielder, though. I thought Salif Jow was a centre mid. Am I getting that wrong, or does anybody else remember Salif Jow being a central midfielder? Maybe I'm getting him mixed up with somebody else, but I don't know. I remember him being like a tough tackling centre mid. Oh, Dale, hi everybody. Cheers, mate. Good to see you. CM said, I got to reading about the Mighty Diamonds yesterday. Have you had a look at their OG players on here, Mike? You mean the players that play for them? What do you mean by OG? You mean players that play for them right now in real life? Yeah, okay. Oh, they're 2002. They're 2012 team. I did, but a lot of them don't exist. Oh, there we go. Salif Jow is in. Salif Jow is in as a right winger. You definitely need to play for the reserves until you're match fit. Garcia can do the same. Driesen can do the same. There we go. Oh, there are two Salif Jows, are there? Uh-oh. Oh, one of them's a coach. Oh, that's the Salif Jow that used to play for Liverpool. Yes, it's a different one. But both of them played for Stoke. Both Salif Jows played for Stoke. Okay, well, that's why we're getting confused. But he is only 22. He's highly, look at it, look, he's really highly rated in every position that he can play. He's definitely a good signing, regardless of whether he's the real Salif Jow or an imposter. Off the back of a lorry Jow. Yeah, exactly. What are the chances, Chuckleberry? I know. Yeah, CM Tid, I did have a look at their I did have a look at the Rutton and Diamonds 2012 squad on this way back when we started the stream ages ago. And a lot of them either don't exist because on the game AFC Rustam weren't a team, and a lot of their I don't know a lot of I don't know where they got most of their players from at the time, but a lot of them just aren't on here. And the ones that were on here either didn't want to play for me at the time, which was understandable because we were in a terrible league, or I don't think they were good enough to have played for us anyway. And we've actually got to the stage now where even if they were available, we wouldn't want them, which is kind of a shame. And I understand it's a shame because we would like to get some, real players in. Oh, my reserves won. Oh, through an own goal. Own goal is our top scorer, I think, this season. But yeah, it's a good suggestion. Yeah, like when Sunderland signed the wrong Milton Nunez. Yeah. Yeah. I really need to watch those Sunderland documentaries. The Sunderland Till I Die, because I know there's a second season now, but I haven't watched the first one yet. I saw some reviews that said the first one was really good and the second season is far less good. So if anybody's seen it, let us know in the chat. I'm curious. Greg Plummer. Not that bothered about you. No, we don't need to do that. I'll have a very quick look at the transfer list just in case. Just in case. I was looking for former internationals the other night. Nah, there's no new internationals on there. Nah. Or former internationals, I should say. We're obviously not signing any current internationals for any clubs we've ever heard of. Awesome. Oh, and a Namibian international, Manfred Stark. Oh, he's actually not bad. He is actually not a bad footballer. career in Germany. Yeah, German second nationality. Let's give him a trial. Why not? Oh, he's got a lot of interest. Manfred Stark. Stark Manfred. Much dirtier. Or Roderick Young as well. I'm a big fan of anyone whose name is Roderick. Yeah, but anyway, this is I know that this is a waste of time. I just occasionally like to see if anybody has appeared on the list who's amazing. There's all these like Brazilian youth players who I could potentially sign, but they won't actually come here till they're 18. So I'd sign them and then wait 3 years for them to arrive, which is obviously a complete waste of time. Yeah, I had a look at, he's quite good. I had a look at a couple of these, but I just don't need to sign more Argentinians, though actually he looks really good. Oh, I couldn't sign him anyway. Yeah, I can't sign him anyway. Yeah, there's the transfer list. There's no point really. There's If I spent ages looking, I might be able to find the odd player that would be a good signing, but we've got a decent squad. Unless we get some injuries. You know, if we get some more injuries at centre half, then I'll start having to look, but at the moment I think we're fine. Sounds like a Bond villain, yeah. Yeah. Yep. The first season is brilliant, says Joan. No, that's cool. That's good to know. That's good to know. Salif, so-called Jao. Yeah. Yeah, CM Tid. Yeah. Alfie Taylor. Oh, I do remember looking for him. I'll have a look, I'll have another quick. Or oh, somebody else. Who else suggested a player before? Sorry, somebody suggested a player for Bury. Where was that? Oh, Carl Deeks. Carl Deeks. No, Carl Deeks. Alfie, what was it? Alfie Taylor. Yeah, there's no Alfie Taylor. That's the a lot of them did, a lot of them don't exist, unfortunately, CM Tid, which is a shame because yeah, I really wanted to sign some of the original Diamonds. Awesome. I signed one guy who plays for Rushden and Diamonds in real life now, and he played for them at the time, I think. It was a central midfielder who I've since released because I didn't need him. I signed him because I wanted to have one of their players, but he didn't do enough. Cronesbury is really developing. We definitely need to keep a beady eye on him. Oh, there's a big game coming up. Blyth Spartans. My former love interest. CM said also Super Soccer Saturday went wrong. What do you mean? What do you mean? You might notice that there's a black bar at the bottom here. From now on, I'm going to put the drinking game rules down there. Oh, went wrong in that you got hammered. Yeah, okay, I understand. Understood. Understood. Yes, we all did. Couldn't look more Irish, that guy. Yeah, he does look pretty Irish. Yeah, I think we all got a little bit pissed on Saturday. Oh, whoops, sorry. Don't worry, everything's fine. I just minimized the game window by accident. And because it's processing, it takes a while to reappear. There we go. Paco Alcacer is at Man City on this, yeah. Forgot there was a. Oh, yes. Some names. Kamil Wiktorski. Not a terrible defender. Not a terrible defender. Let's put him in the reserves for a month. Let's see how he gets on. Oh, Timothy Mjällby. I kind of want to sign him just for the name and because he's Swedish and because he used to play for Celtic. Let's give him a trial as well. Yeah, it's not every stream we win seven on the bounce and score 22 goals. In fact, not only is it not every stream, I don't think that's ever happened before. It was remarkable. Remarkable. Okay, this is going to be a tough game because of my past and my history with Blyth Spartans. Regardless of where they are in the league, my former teams always come back to haunt me. Let's just quickly see where they are in the league, actually. They are. Where are they? Oh, there they are, 14th. Yeah, they've not had a rip-roaring start to the season. We, on the other hand, are absolutely bossing it. Are we only 8 points clear? What happened with that? I thought we were 9 points clear. Maybe I miscalculated the other day. But yeah, I mean, look at this start. Ignore the friendlies. Don't worry about the friendlies. Look at that. Only one game that we haven't won. What a start to the season. Absolutely disgraceful, outrageous, disgusting, and all those other words. Okay, right. I mean, the question is, who comes out? We'll give Alonso a break. Oh, actually, no, hang on. Let's have a quick look. Omar's only at 94. He's always the least fit, so he can swap with Alonso. Take these two off the bench. Stud can come back in for Sosa, because Sosa did okay last game, but the stud is better, I think. Bernardo's okay on the side. Marveggio, yeah, he's okay on the side. Actually, I'll put Salif Jow on the bench so that he can get a bit of... He's only at 83%, but we need to build up his match fitness. Oh, Capolino is back as well. Okay, he can come in for Gustan. Which means that... Oh, God, it's so hard to know who to pick. Let's just go on form. Got to pick it on form. Oh, well, Caroma and Alonso on recent form. And actually, Capolino, 7.02 from recent form. Okay, well, in that case, we'll do this. We'll do that. Ajnani, attacking midfield centre. Actually, no. Alonso was really good in that central midfield position. So I'll keep him in attacking midfield centre. Yeah, there we go. There we go. You should pick players based on form, really. I know I don't do it very often, but you should. Bernardo is just not one of them. Capolino can come back onto the bench. I mean, Bernardo scored that absolute raker of a goal. Yeah, okay, we'll go with that. We'll go with that. That seems fair. Timothy is Johan Mjalby's son. Oh, no way. We'll definitely get that then. We'll definitely get him. Yeah, NJ, it was the Celtic kid. How without? Yeah, not quite Zola's son, but get him in the air. Yeah, you're right. Okay, right. That'll do. Are we away? I think we are. We'll go counter again. Counter generally works well when we're away. Yeah, we'll take that. Oh, they've got a Moncrief up front. I've got a mate called Moncrief. They've got a Moncrief, an Armstrong, and Neville. Oh, they've got R. Kelly, centre half. Oh, Jesus. Everybody, just stay away from him. Just stay away from him. Hide your daughters, whatever you do. Right back, Caroma. Left back. I always hate to see a Neville. I don't know. The surname Neville just gets my hackles up. And it's not because I wasn't a fan of the Nevilles or like Man United or anything like that. There are just so many Nevilles and they always play well, I feel like. Right, here we go. Here we go. My former flames, Blythe Spartans, against my new loves, my forever loves, AFC Rushden and Diamonds. Come on, boys. Let's give them a good smashing. Great start. Lovely. Go on, stud. Go on, stud. Yes, just leaves him in his wake. Oh, he's crossed it. Alonso. Oh, last ditch block. So unlucky. Oh, nice. That's good. Omar puts him under pressure. Alonso skips past his man. Oh, Alonso should have shot. So unselfish. Alonso just danced past his man. Really like Fulton in that defensive midfield position. It's a shame he's on a non-contract, because I'll probably end up losing him to a team about three divisions above. The other thing we're struggling with a bit is not being professional. Oh, studs into the box. Oh, we're struggling with not being professional. That's another thing that's is going to cause us to lose players, because they can't train. Oh my God, Ajnani. They can't train professionally, obviously, because they can only they can't train full time. So they're only going to develop so much. You know, you need to have your young players training full time in order for them to actually develop to the potential that they can. So we're going to suffer with that a little bit. Come on, boys. What a great bit. Oh, this is just such a good move. Stud's been forced wide. Omar's just ridden that tackle. Seen it off like the rock. Oh, Busby into the box. Busby scores. Keeper definitely should have saved it since he got two hands to it, but just the fierceness of the shot. A rasping, venomous hit from Busby. Knight can do nothing. 1-0 to your mighty Diamonds. Busby does so well here. Look at this. Just dances away from that challenge. Brilliant second, third touch into the box. Just rifles it. Keeper should definitely save it. No complaints. Commentary you don't hear very often. The stud leaves him in his wake. Yeah, it's quite true. Oh, yeah, keep Venema away from R. Kelly. I shouldn't have played him. Half-time. Great first half. R. Kelly in midfield. I think he's in, isn't he playing in defence for them? Anyway, it's a good first half. Keep it up. Yeah, great. That was a great goal. It was a really great hit. If we can get to 2-0, then I'll start thinking about putting Salif Jow on for Ake or someone. Maybe one of my wingers comes off. Old stud into the box. Oh, blocked again. Yeah, Omar and Adjanani look like they both need to come off at this rate. Which we should be able to accommodate fairly easily. Oh. Adjanani is on a yellow and with an injury and not doing amazingly. So Adjanani is almost definitely coming off. Great header away. Omar, you've got to get there. Omar, what are you doing? Yeah, DMC, you're right. At the moment, Turn Professional's grayed out. And if I hover over it with the mouse, it says you don't have the money to turn professional. So it seems that finances is actually the part of the reason. But yeah, I don't know if you'd be able to turn professional in this division anyway. Go on, Adjanani. Oh, the child flicks it in. Oh, stud can't quite get on the end of it. Right, we'll take Adjanani off for Cap. Alonso can go left as an inside forward. Cap in midfield, that's fine. We'll just keep that for now. We're not playing amazingly here. I'm a little bit concerned. I would really like a second goal because while they haven't really done much coming forward so far, as we know, all it takes is one shot from 45 yards and this game will finish 1-1. This is a good move. Good block, Ake. Well done. Excellent. The child has got... That wasn't one of his better crosses either. That's the other thing. But he has got a really good cross on him. I think we'll preemptively bar the... Oh, no, because we're not... Oh, no! See what I mean? Ah, no. I'm worried because I don't think we're really playing well enough to win this at the moment. That was a really good header. Good corner. Alonso misses it. He goes up for it, but he completely misses his jump. Good header. Good goal. Damn it. Gaff. This all happened since you arrived, Gaff. It was going fine until you got here. Welcome. This is a problem. Because Rosso's on a 5.8. Swap him with Albrechtsen. Let Albrechtsen have corners instead. I haven't got a centre-back to bring on. I don't want to bring Jow on now. Actually, you know what? Yeah, we'll bring him on for Omar, who's tired and booked. And we'll bring Sosa on for Alonso. And we'll go to this little dealer here. Venema attack. Wing-back attack. Here we go. Come on, boys. We're going to come off counter as well. We'll go control. Actually, sod it. You know what? We'll go attacking. It's only a few minutes left. I'd rather lose than draw. I'd rather go for it and lose. Stupid. It's ridiculous philosophy, but I hate draws. I genuinely would rather go for it and lose than not go for it and draw. Do or die. Cap. Astudillo. Oh, just too far ahead of the Stade. Come on. Still time. Busby. Oh, what a header. Oh, no, he's offside. Oh, no. Oh, I can't believe it. What a great header from Busby. He absolutely sailed through the sky. Oh. Gutting. Absolutely gutting. Come on, guys. Last couple of minutes. Cap, Stud. Busby. Oh, he's made it to Stud. Oh, Stud's rattled it in. Stud's made it 2-1. 91st minute. Busby assist. Come on. Really good goal. Oh, I honestly thought that wasn't going to happen. Lovely ball from Busby. Oh, Stud. Superb. Take it back to counter just for the last couple of minutes of extra time or stoppage time. Oh, what a great win. What an excellent win. Mark of champions, that. Yeah, very good. Oh, man. Oh, look at that. 14 points clear. What has happened, rest of the league? What has happened? Look at this. AFC Rushden, 40 points. Geisley behind us with only 26. What a lead. Paul time, yeah. Yeah. Oh, the Alan Pardew School of Football Management works, though, doesn't it? It works occasionally. Ah, mate. When you win and not playing well, exactly. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, they fear, exactly, Gaff. They fear the Stud. Gaff. I just saw all your Paul outs and your adios. Lads, that was such a good win. I knew it would be tough as well, didn't I? I said it would be tough. My former teams always come back. Journeyman striker Rodrigo Astudillo clinched the late winner. Busby shines. Yeah, Busby was really it. We're definitely going to lose him. He's not going to sign. He won't sign a new contract under any circumstances. I'm really gutted that we're going to lose him. Contract's up at the end of the season. Such a shame. He's going to go somewhere and become the best midfielder in the world. When we finally get to the Premier League, he's going to be in midfield for Man United or something, for sure. No doubt about it. Gutting. Whatever, Tommy Cassidy. It's loser talk. It's just, I need to have a quick look at the table. Oh, look at that. 36 goal difference, 40 points from our opening 14 games. Absolutely outrageous start to the season. Journeyman, weird way to spell non-league legend. Exactly, they all fear the Stud. Yep, CM Tidge, you're absolutely right. He might not play well, but he always comes up with the goods. That's the thing, is if you put the ball in front of him, inside the box, or even just outside the box, he hits the target pretty regularly. In the games where he doesn't hit the target, they're the ones that I think about taking him off because I feel like something must be wrong. Come on. Exactly. To use one of Dr. Benji's, where is it? One of Dr. Benji's emojis. Come on. Excellent stuff. Oh, Bury Town are next. Bury Town away. We'll make a few changes for that game because we'll probably have to because it's only... Oh, it's actually in a week. Oh, I thought it would be midweek. That's okay. We've got a bit of time to recover. But we'll probably bring... I might give Salif Giao a start at right back. Look, Ake and Alonso are both needing a rest. So I might... I could actually send them both on holiday for a week, can't I? Which helps them get over it. Another 65 grand in the bank. Nice. Can I do send on holiday? Yeah, I can send them on holiday for a week. Let me just make sure I'm not going to completely louse everything up. Yeah, so it's only Sunday, so they'll be back next Sunday, so they'll miss the Bury Town game, but that's okay. Because, well, first of all, these two aren't playing for us anyway, so they can both go. We can take out Alonso and Ake, give them a rest. There we go, let's do that. Give them a rest. Send them on holiday for a week. Yeah, DMAC. genuinely excited about playing Bury Town. Bit of a derby for me. Yeah, it'll be good. Yeah, but where do your loyalties lie, DMAC? That's the important thing. Are you a sleeper agent? Are you in disguise? Gaff, next level is the conference. Yeah, conference premier or the blue square bet premier as it is on this. RVX, we've got to hit double figures against Eastwood. You know that I'll be drinking if we do. I didn't look at them. Are they bottom of the table by a mile? I didn't see. I'll have a quick look when we're back from processing. But yeah, genuine. Yeah, it's going to be good. Oh, DMAC, rush until I die. That's the boy. That's what I like to hear. I need to go and get myself some water. Yeah, I saw earlier in the season that Eastwood, they lost at least one game really heavily. They must have won. They must have lost a lot more. If you're saying that, we'll take a look. Oh, CM Tid, that's interesting facts. I was reading about why we're in the North. The existence of the Isthmian League means that sometimes Southern teams get kicked into the Northern League. I mean, it makes sense. It makes sense that occasionally there's going to be some. Do you? Funny. Oh, actually. Oh, hang on. Oh, goalkeeping coach is leaving at the end of the season. And Fortune. That's okay. Okay, so they've all gone away on leave. That's fine. How do they decide? Are we the most like northerly team? Do you know? Does it say how they get to? How they get divided up? Because that's the thing I'm curious about, is that why was it us that got put in there? Was it because, oh, actually, Zhao needs to not play in that reserve game. I'm just curious as to why we were the ones that got bumped. Is it because we're the most northerly team? Yeah, they generally choose the most northerly team, yeah. Oh, Birchie's got a clean vent, everyone. I haven't got a drink, but cheers to you, Birchie. Good for you, mate. All right. Yeah, we'll have a few changes for the next game. Not many, though. It's a good opportunity to give Cedric Ake and Sebastian Alonso a week off if they're both already tired. It's only the end of October and they're both showing their tiredness. Actually, you know what I should also do? I should put this on support. Hopefully that will help Ake to be less knackered every week. Yes, Busby and Team of the Week. I will never stop trying to give him a new contract. I should have given him an extra year when I signed him. But the thing is that I was not in the... Oh, God damn it. Luis Enrique concerned. End of the season. Yeah, you can go at the end of the season. I imagine his contract is up at the end of the season anyway. He's on non-contract terms. Just leave whenever you want, Lewis. Oh, Manfred's in. He's in on trial. The M25, yeah. Yeah, we can't have Chugger sitting in the M25. He'd never start back up again. Especially if it rains. Oh, that'd be the end of it. We'd be stuck on the M25 forever. Michael Gardavsky unhappy about lack of first team football. Okay, let's have a look at Stark. Okay, that's left midfield, but how about left back? Well, okay, if he was better than the Panzer, then I would think about signing him. But the thing is that he's worse than the Panzer, and I'm not getting rid of Melvin under any circumstances, so... There isn't really a place for Manfred unless he wants non-contract terms. Oh, he does. Oh, he's... Right, okay. In that case, you can go into the reserves. That's fine. Bury Town want one of my players on loan. Sneaky. Very, very sneaky. I don't think so because I might need him. Sorry, Bury Town. Nice try stealing one of my defenders to play against me and inevitably score a hat-trick or something. Yeah, I see you. Timothy Mialbi is in on trial. L- Little bit of a save. I really need to go and get some water. I might just go and get a beer. Is anybody drinking? Is anybody drinking this afternoon, or is everybody working? Working. Bonnie is working. DMAC, we're away against Bury because my cup games are always away. I almost always get away draws. Yeah, Bury trying the whole unsettle the squad, exactly. I know that one because I do it as well. Before we played Real Madrid in the Champions League, I actually agreed an end of season deal with Fernando Morientes just to try and unsettle him, and then cancelled it. Mialbi, has he got the potential? Oh, he has got quite good potential. Okay. Yes, Tim Mialbi, youth contract. Take him. Enrique can play for the reserves. Rago can play for the reserves. Daly can play for the reserves. Oh no, actually he's match fit, that's fine. Stark should be in the reserves. Mialbi should be in the under-18s. There we go. Good. We've got to beat Berrytown, haven't we, surely? Surely we've got to make it through. Oh, it's a bank holiday. Birchie's on tea. I'll take a tea, Birchie. Cheers, mate. I'll take one. Ooh, Andre Scarlett. Cool name. Bit old. Oh, it's a bank holiday. Yeah, bank holiday. Oh, CM Tid. Caught a spoiler about Calderos, yeah. Oh, Zakid, welcome back. Yeah, we are in a new season. We're absolutely smashing it. Let me just quickly show you what we've done so far. Kaboom. It's been an absolute whitewash, apart from that 0-0 draw with Tamworth. But even still, it's just been... We're just romping to the Blue Square Bet North title. Romping. And we're in the fourth qualifying round of the FA Cup, which is what we've got next. Let's have a quick look at this defender, see if he's any good. He's gone on trial just in time for this reserve game. Actually, no, he might just miss it. So, Max, if it's a bank holiday today, presumably you've got a tin open. Oh, DMAC taking the stud out in Bury for night on the town. You know what? Next season, once everything's... Yeah, everything in the world is relatively back to normal. I would love to go to an AFC Ruston game. Our reserves won 5-1. Let's have a quick look at this kid. He's not bad. He's not a bad centre-half compared to the rest of our squad, and he's got good potential. Oh, he wants non-contract. We'll take him as well then. 5-1. Oh, Timothy Mialbi is the team's top performer. Scored from the edge of the area. Oh, he scored twice. Oh, let's have a quick look at these goals. You'll all have to just indulge me here, but if my reserves win 5-1 and Timothy Mialbi scores twice, I feel like I have to watch the goals. Oh, shoot from there. Oh, he does. What a finish. What a strike from Mialbi. Very nice. Okay, he's next. Oh, Stark. Stark Forest. Oh, Stark takes it off him. Oh, Howarth. Unleashing all his frustration at not playing for the first team. Roll on. Oh, Enrique back post. Oh, he injures Hinchcliffe as well. Just rubs it in. Very nice. I think this was their goal. Not interested in their goal. I want to see our goals. Oh, Mialbi. My God. Two absolute thunder bastards from the edge of the box. That was incredible. Okay. I'm a big fan of him. I think there's a reasonable chance we're going to see Timothy Mialbi before the end of the season. Oh, and Garcia gets one as well. Wow. My centre mid's just taking the piss. Very good. Okay, excellent. Ah, oh, it's a tea all the way. Fair enough. Oh, Penna, welcome back. Penna, welcome back. Yep. Yeah, Mialbi. That was pretty impressive. Well, that wasn't Johan Mialbi, though. That was Tim Mialbi. So, sign him up. Yeah, we've got him. We've got him. He's in. He's in my under-18s. Yeah, I am going to go to an AFC Ruston game one day, and I'll definitely let you all... I'll give all of you as much notice as I can. Because if anybody's free that weekend, maybe we could all go to an AFC Ruston home game together. I was going to say we could go to an away game in a city that's nearer to everybody, but it seems like everybody's scattered all over the place. It'd be a good laugh, wouldn't it? Go for a night out in Wellingborough. Oh, actually, no, they don't play in Wellingborough any. I don't actually know where they play now. I don't know where the real-life ground is. Melvin, Henk de Jong, Jacob Murphy have been impressing on the training ground. Yeah, Jacob Murphy's going to play before the end of the season as well. Play again. He's already played once. Oh, how is he get? How is the Nuneaton manager getting the Manager of the Month award? I guess it would just be embarrassing for them to choose me every single week. There we go. Every month, I mean, sorry. Tim Mialbi is in. After those two goals for the reserves, he's played his way into a contract. I was going to sign him anyway, to be completely honest. Outrageous. We should pay Ralphie B to get us a director's box. Oh, maybe, yeah, maybe, maybe. Yeah, it's his son, Penner. It's Mialbi's son. Mike on the throne at the local night spot. We'll have to go to the Dog and Duck, 100%. There was somebody was in, that was in the chat who hasn't been online for a while. I think it was... I can't remember who it was. Somebody lives in Wellingborough from the chat who I haven't seen for a while. Yes, Tim Mialbi. Yeah, Mialbi might be the one to get on the back of your shirt. Oh, well. He's in. Timothy Mialbi. And I got him in on a 2-year contract as well. Smart. See, thinking about it. I mean, he might end up replacing Busby at this rate, Nathan Busby. Because as much as I love Busby, again, if he's not going to sign a new contract, I will start to get tired of him. We'll see. Maybe he'll come around as the season goes on. Maybe. Dinner at Vince's. Yeah, definitely dinner at Vince's Fish Bar. 100%. Maybe they'll tour Valencia. Maybe. Who knows, Gaff? Then you, at least you and I can then go. AFC Rushton against Levante pre-season friendly. Who knows? Who knows? But yeah, I'll definitely let Ralphie B know if we're all going to an AFC Rushton game. For sure. No question. I'm sure he'd love to see us. He's been so good to us on Twitter and just in general. He's been really supportive of the stream. That's very kind of him. Right. Craig Ferris still doesn't have a club. Oh, at least somebody's interested in him. I really hope he gets another team. Berry Town. So sneaky. Now, he is available. I've got him on the loan list, to be fair. I'll change him to unavailable for loan. Get out of here. Oh, let's have a press conference for Timothy Mialbi. I'm always looking to build for the future. Yep. He's a good player who can... Yeah, we'll just keep him happy. No comment. There we go. Cool. Okay, lads. Here we go. FA Cup fourth qualifying round. Oh, not quite yet. Well, in a minute. We're going to keep a reasonably similar team. There's going to be a couple of changes. As you saw, because I've let Alonso and Ake, little Ricky, go on holiday. So Salif Diao can have a start, his first start at right back. We'll keep the rest of the defence in place. We'll take Busby out for Garcia. Oh no, Garcia just played in that reserve game, so he's tired. Okay, we'll put Marveggio back in then for Busby. Again, as much as I love Busby, I now that he's not signing a new contract, I'm pretty upset. Little bastard. Okay, well, we'll take, you know what, we'll just keep playing Busby. He's really good, so we should just keep playing him. Capolino must need match fitness. Oh, he's at 81%. About Bernardo, who's at the lower? 76, yeah, okay. Bernardo can start attacking midfield. We'll give Sosa a go up front. Just be, you know, we are still playing a team in the league below us. Seven subs, oh yeah, seven subs, thank you. Gaff, what happened to Dugan? Oh, well, I had this shotgun that I'd never used, and I was really curious. No, I just released him on a free transfer. No, CM Tid, if we win this, we're in the first round. First round proper. I think, well, Esteves is only meant to be a reserve anyway, but he is severely lacking in match fitness, so he can go on the bench too. So that's two defenders, two midfielders. No, three midfielders and a striker on the bench. Fulton, Kaplan. Yeah, so we've got options on the bench for players who could come on. Actually, we'll do Rago on the bench. So we've got players that could come on. Actually, no, yeah, okay, that'll do. We'll do that. Did anyone pick him up? I think somebody did. No, nobody has, unfortunately. He could end up at Arthurley in Scotland or at Northwich Victoria, so things are looking up. I mean, he will end up in the division above us for about one season, and then we're going to be a rocket to the moon. Dugan's going to be stuck in the reserves forever. Right, here we go, lads. Oh, it's a big game. Bury Town away. Fourth qualifying round of the FA Cup. I think I'm going to go control for this one. Esteves on the opposition advice. Right back, left back. Team talk. Show me what you can do. Oh, Marveggio loves it. What a hero. Control. Boom. Come on, boys. A place in the first round proper of the FA Cup is at stake. I am genuinely sweating. Because even though we are better than them in terms of the league structure, it's just a big game, so nervous. Oh, Busby, great ball back in. Oh, Sosa off the post. I thought he was offside. He looked off. I haven't read that Athletic article, Tim. Send me a link on Twitter. Busby. Oh, Yilmaz Aksoy in goal for Bury Town. Love the name. Excellent name. Yeah, tweet me, tag me in the link on Twitter. Oh, Sosa's in again. Oh, unlucky. Good start. Very good start. They're playing more defensively now. That's good. Just keep the push back. Oh, Sosa! Oh, what a great ball in from the literal child. Another wonderful cross from Melvin. Great header from Sosa. 1-0 AFC Rushden. It's the lead I wanted. I really wanted an early lead. I mean, 21 minutes isn't early, but it's fine. It's early enough. First half lead, I should say. Great cross from Melvin. Sosa's really good in the air. Keeper should save it. Who cares? Who cares, lads? Yeah, the child has to be... the child has to be a fan favourite. Oh, Omar's up as well! Oh, flicked onto the crossbar and over. So close to 2-0. Yeah, I said it last season. I feel like Melvin Venema, the literal child, it could be a player that stays with us all the way up the leagues. Because he's young enough that you can see him continually signing new contracts. But he's good enough that he's going to play. But he's not good enough to I thought that was in. He's not good enough to be poached by like a Premier League team. I even think that because he's still only got 5 silver stars, I don't think a team from the league above will try and take him. Oh, that's a good bit of dribbling. Great tackle, Albrechtsen. Yeah, I feel like Venema is the sort of player that we could have for good. He could be a lifer, a one-club kid, a one-club man. He'll be a 17-year-old forever. Great ball from Busby. Oh my God, he's so good. Omar's there. Oh, Omar finds it. Omar wins it back. Keeper didn't get back in time. Superb. Superb. Excellent. Here we go. Busby. Oh my God, we're going to miss him. I'm so gutted I didn't sign him on a longer deal. Oh well. I mean, I was so desperate to sign him that I probably couldn't have. He probably would have only taken a one-year deal anyway. Or actually, you know what? I did sign him on a two-year deal, but he didn't join us for a year. So maybe that's part of it. Oh, Jiao in. Oh, Karoma again. Oh, a net buster from Omar. Absolute net buster. He is loving it out there, Omar Karoma. Flat track bully. Found his level. Just smashing Berrytown to pieces. Feel my Funyuns, welcome. Thanks for reading Los Coloneros. You join us at a great time. Busby's contract is up at the end of the... Oh, Omar's injured. Oh, it wouldn't be a game. Oh, he can wait till halftime. Oh, great diving header. Yeah, Busby's just not going to sign a new contract because he's too good for us and he knows it. So he'll have to go at the end of the season, I would have thought. But then who knows? I mean, maybe the Blue Square Bet Premier is all he's looking for. So if we get promoted, he might change his mind. Great ball. Sosa. Oh, Sosa. Should have made it four. There'll be plenty more Wonder Kids. Exactly. Yeah. Yeah. Karoma. Oh, it's offside. Oh, Karoma nearly got a first half hat trick. He's coming off at halftime anyway. For sure. Buried, yep. Yeah, this has been a good half. We couldn't have asked for much more. Do a professional job against a perceived weaker team, but we're at their place. Anything can happen away. Keep it going. We're going to take Omar off. Well, I'm going to have to think about it, actually. We'll put Rago on and let Salif Jiao go into the wing. That seems like... Estevez... I could put Estevez on, but he really is a reserve player. I'd rather make sure that Rago is match fit in case we need him. Oh, Busby, what a ball in. Oh, how has Bernardo missed that? How's he missed? That's a classic, you know, unmissable chance that still manages to go wide. It's like watching Maximus Igalco. Oh, Ajnani. Oh, Ajnani had done so well. Crossed it to nobody. Oh, great challenge, Albrechtsen. Lovely. The man taking a bit of a chance there. Did really well, though. Get after that, Sosa. Oh. Unlucky. Uh-oh. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, that had disaster written all over it, but the man, cool, calm and collected. Okay, we're nearly on second sub time. Great ball in, Busby. Oh, he's offside. Oh, my God. What a great ball in, though. Okay. Let's give Kellen Daly a debut. For Rosso and who else is tied? Bernardo. Oh yeah, we'll put Estevez on for Bernardo then. There we go. That'll do it. Don't need to risk the stud. There's no need. I mean, he'd have an absolute field day out there, but he might as well get his night out in Bury started early. Oh. Bernardo made a great run. Go on, Salif. Oh, well wide. Miles wide. Yeah, CM Tid, Karoma is the very definition of a club legend. Firing us into the FA Cup first round, then getting injured. Yeah, he's so unselfish. Gets himself injured so he can't play in the first round game, but he still gets us there. Yeah, D-Mac has got to be very careful. Oh, no. Ah, that's fine. Oh, Sosa, I love the commitment. I love Sosa up front. I love Sosa up front so much that I'm tempted to go to a front two because I want to play him and the stud together. But then you have to take somebody out, and I've got so many good attacking midfield players. I don't want to take anybody out. Ah, oh, the child has done really well there. Oh, Adjnani. Oh, I thought he was going to find a raker of a pass. Go on, Salif. Yes. Oh, referee. Oh, Luke, cheers, mate. Thanks for coming back. See you next time. Oh, Adjnani. Oh. Saved.
I'm getting tired of how brilliant we are.
Oh, Daly! Oh, Daly on his debut. I really want him to score. What a start to his career at AFC Rushden that would be. Go on, Daly. Go on, Daly. Oh, so close. Man, so close. You know what? Bury Town have looked decent on the counter, I've got to say. They've actually looked all right a couple of times. They've counter-attacked us better than teams in our division this season. But yeah, DMAC, if they score in the last 2 minutes, you've got to remember not to celebrate, otherwise you'll get in trouble. Great tackle, Albrechtsen. It's time to start calling the child the adolescent soon. Yeah, once he's 18, we could call him the adolescent. Get a coffee, Penicott. Oh, I've had a lot of coffee today already. I actually think this might be the coffee come down. That might be part of the problem. And just general exhaustion from playing Los Calderos, honestly. Just so tiring, that emotionally draining episode. Oh, Salif Jow loves it. Oh, Salif, unlucky. Come on, ref. That'll do. This game's over. This game's been over for an hour. Can't question Busby's commitment for the time being. He's committed for the next 6 months. Yeah, I'm not going to make a Sebastian Heroux-style mistake this time. If somebody's playing well, if Busby's doing what he's been doing recently, which is getting loads of our assists and just generally being amazing. Martin, you're going to make Arya's first words Paul out, Funyuns. Better not. Go on, get after that. Oh, it's all over. Yes. FA Cup first round, here we come. That was a nice, easy game. Nice and easy. Just eased our way through it beautifully. Yeah, CMTG, you're right. You're right. If no one steals him, he might still sign for us once we're in the conference. You're absolutely right. So I forget which teams join at the first round stage. Is it League One and League Two? Yeah, DMAC, off to the avenue. Let's all get down the avenue and have some celebratory drinks. Oh, some big wins. Okay. 13 grand. Cherno Samba, man of the match for someone else. Ah, oh, there we go. Robbie Garvey. Somebody's finally given us the praise we deserve, the recognition we deserve. I think it's at least League One and Two. Yeah, League One and Two. Feel my Funyuns wants Northampton at home. Who's the worst possible team we could get? Let's go and take a look. Whoever's top of League One at the moment. Because whoever it is, we'll get them away. I can almost guarantee it. Okay. Coventry or Watford? would be the worst teams we could get. Coventry or Watford away. Right. That's who we're going to get. Oh, yes. Manfred's in. Manfred Stark is in. He is a diamond geezer, and he's in the reserves where he belongs. Sorry. Sorry, Manfred. There's no place for you here in the first team. There is a place for you in the reserves, not the first team. Could well get our parent club, says Martin. Yeah, that now that wouldn't be a surprise. Colchester, yeah. That would not be a surprise. It's another thing that you find happens. Okay, I'm going to quickly confirm this signing. Is he in the reserves already? Yeah. Okay, FA Cup first round draw. 84 teams going in. I really want to do automatic draw, but there are so many teams. We'll do automatic draw for a bit, just in case we come out early. Just in case. I wish there was a way of speeding it up. You know what? I can just do it myself, can't I? I can do draw next team. Billericay. Oh, Billericay would have been good. Oh, we haven't got Coventry. We've avoided Coventry. Torquay, Oxford. Oh, Bournemouth. Oh, Bournemouth, Fleetwood. Decent game. Jamie Vardy. Give Bournemouth a good seeing too. Oh, Aldershot. Please don't let me play Aldershot away. Oh, Aldershot. I've got Watford. Oh, what a game. What a game. Well, we've avoided Coventry and Watford, everyone. Oh, Cambridge. Oh, Northampton Barnet. York, Eastbourne. Oh, scroll down a little bit. Oh, no. Won't let me scroll down. Okay, Rotherham, Blythe. Oh, Boreham Wood. Oh, Luton. Bromley on Newport County against Stevenage. Oh, no, not Chesterfield, please. Okay, good. Chesterfield, Swindon, that's good. Crewe atop of the Blue Square Premier. Oh, Portsmouth. Oh, that's a good game as well. Gillingham are my best mates team. Oh, Bishop Stortford. Thank goodness we haven't got Gillingham. I'd never have heard the end of it if we'd lost to Gillingham. Oh, Hayes and Yedding are a good side in the Premier. Oh, we've avoided them as well. Solihull Moors we've got. Away, obviously. I'm always away. But Solihull are in our division. It's not really the game I wanted. I actually would have rather had Coventry away. But, you know, we're always going to get... I always draw away cup games. So Solihull Moors it is. A fellow Blue Square North team. Eighth in the league at the moment. I don't think we've played them, have we, so far this season? Oh, no, we've got... Oh, we've got them two in a row. We've got them at home in the cup. And home in the league. And then away in the cup. Well, lads. A double header against Solihull. Yep. Prize money. Think of the prize money. Yeah, I mean, to be honest, really, it's all about getting to the third round now. Really, what we want is teams that we can beat until the third round. And then we want Arsenal away or Man United away or, you know, and just a Premier League team away is what we want. Just so badly, I want that. So, yeah, we haven't got them next, but we've got them soon. Penner, exactly, gives us a chance to go to the next round. Yeah, and virtually any draw is a good... Well, that's not true, actually. So you either want a really terrible team that you can beat or you want a really good team that will be a spectacular day. What you don't want is the other thing that happens to me a lot, so I'm just going to say it right now because it does, is that I'll get some middling rubbish team. So what will happen is we'll fight and claw our way all the way to the third round of the FA Cup and then we'll get, like, Macclesfield away and then they'll beat us and it'll... be a massive anticlimax. That happens to me a lot on Chat Manager and Football Manager. It hasn't happened so much in Diamond Geezers or Los Colorados, but on the newer ones, on the Football Managers, that always happens. You know, when there's the prospect of, you know, an absolute dream of an away day to a Premier League team, I always get some knobbers in League One that are good enough to knock you out, but the whole thing is just, you know, a fart in a lift. Yeah. Yeah, DMC, classic FM. Get drawn in the cup against the team you play the week before in the year. It is classic. It is classic. Okay, players return from leave. Yeah, we're not having a... Not going to call a press conference for reserve players. Come on, do me a favour. Oh, FA Trophy. FA Trophy, right. Who have we got in the FA Trophy then? This is a cup that we could have a proper go at. We're just going to do draw all teams this time. Oh, look, we're away. What a surprise. To Leighton, our old friends Leighton. Well, that's okay. We know we can have Leighton. We could have beat, we beat Leighton two seasons ago, so we'll beat them now. Very good. But yeah, I hope you guys like away days, because every single cup game we get will be away, because it always is. I actually think in these earlier football managers, it's misprogrammed. I genuinely do. The regularity with which I get away draws in the cup, and we're seeing it here. It's happening. It's just happening again. It happens every time in the older football managers. I'm sure it's misprogrammed deliberately to, or maybe it's deliberately, yeah, maybe it's deliberately programmed to stitch you up so you always get difficult cup draws. But yeah, I'm convinced of it. I'm convinced it's either a bug in the game, or the game has been programmed deliberately. It's one of the two, because it certainly isn't random. That's for sure. Starbury, my buddy Neil with Havant & Waterlooville played Liverpool at Anfield. Oh yeah, I love stories like that. It's like that season that Stevenage, is it Stevenage Borough, I think, when they had they had the striker. I want to say Pesca Salido, but it wasn't him. It was another striker. They had a striker that was English, but he had an Italian sounding surname, and I think he scored against Newcastle at Stevenage, and it was just, I think it was Stevenage. Maybe I'm remembering that wrong. Grazioli is the correct answer, Lotto180. Welcome to the chat, and welcome to the chat with some incredible knowledge. Yes, it was Giuliano Grazioli. I remember around that time I had an FM game going, and I became England manager, and I had a policy which I'll extend to this if I ever become England manager. Which is that whenever we had a friendly game coming up, I would always call up the top scorer from the conference into the England squad and give them at least a half in the friendly against whoever we were playing. And one time I called up Grazioli. It was around that time. Grazioli on my game was the top scorer in the conference. So I called him up to the England, my England squad for a friendly, and he scored a hat trick. We were playing somebody like San Marino. But, I mean, he was playing next to, like, Sheringham, Shearer, Scholes, Beckham, you know. So people just putting the ball in front of him, and he was basically playing against the part-time team, and he scored a hat-trick for England. It's amazing. It's one of my still one of my favourite FM moments, that. Did he play for Rushden? I didn't know that. And, yeah, RVX, not going to do a press conference for a reserve player. Other than Mjällby. Oh yeah, Mjällby's a megastar. He's an instant megastar. But yeah, I'm convinced that champ manager, football manager, cup draws are always not fixed as such, but there's something definitely wrong with the draws. Definitely. If I could put money down now that every single cup game we play this season is away, I would. Because it happens too frequently to be random, I'm sure of it. Bit like Nugent getting a game for England, Gaff, yeah, and Michael Ricketts. Yeah, and Franny Jeffers. My God, that Australia friendly where Franny Jeffers came on. That was such a shocking game. I remember watching that. I was at uni. I remember it so clearly for some reason, because I was in an Australian bar watching it, because I thought it would be good atmosphere. And it was, because we lost. We were expected to smash Australia. I think, didn't they beat us 2-1? Nugent might have scored in that game. I don't remember. Oh, Funyuns, you might have signed him. Yeah, I wonder if he's... Giuliano Grazioli. Oh, he's still around. He's an assistant manager at Barnet. Wow. Seriously gone up in the world, Giuliano. Well, we'll we'll subscribe to him. Like, share, and subscribe. Oh. Our next Blue Square North game against Alfreton. Oh my God, we've only got... We've actually got a really tricky run of games coming up. I mean, in terms of the dates, they're just coming thick and fast. Wednesday, Saturday, we're going to have to think about this. So we're going to have to play... We want our strongest team available for Solihull there. So that's going to be second team first. So I have to play a weakened team against Alfreton, which is tough because they are... doing quite well. Where are Gainsborough in the league? Oh, second. Jesus, we've got some tough games. So we've got Alfreton, who are fifth, then Gainsborough, then Solihull again. Oh, this is tough. We're going to have to play a slightly weaker team for this game so that we're fit for the next one. It's a bit of a tough break. But it's okay because we pretty much have to play a weakened team for this game. Because everyone's knackered from the last one anyway. So Rago isn't really fit, but he's fitter than Zhao. It's okay. Ake can go on the bench. Defence is looking all right, but we're going to give... you know what? I might just... Where's that centre-back gone? Oh, what have I done with him? Did I ditch him all the way to my reserves? I don't think I meant to do that. Luis Enrique. He's not meant to be in my reserves. Luis Enrique can play. Yeah, he's at 95%. That's fine. He can play instead of Albrechtsen because Rosso's recent form has been better. Plus, that's two South Americans. Well, we'll keep Daly on the bench. I'll take Ake out, actually. We'll keep Daly on the bench and he can come on for Rosso. We'll play the child in this game and Panzer can play in the next one, I think. Or should that be the other way around? Yeah, no, that's the wrong way around. Panzer in this one. Alonso is fit, but we don't necessarily need to play him. We could swap. We could play Garcia and Fulton in midfield. Capolino can come. Oh, actually, no, Bernardo can stay in. And Sosa. Because actually, I prefer Astudillo and Capolino, which means they can both come in for the next game. But, oh, Howarth can go on the bench for this one. And Estevez can go on the bench as well, I think, unless... No, we want to bring Adjani out. God, the calculations in my mind are just... Oh, you know what? I need to do a little bit of... We're going to... Oh, wait. Hang on. I was going to say, where's all my reserves gone? It's because I put these filters on. Well, we do have a lot of reserves. Oh, it's the under-18s are in there as well. Ah, there we go. Okay, thank goodness for that. Right, we'll bring Byron back up into the seniors. And also, I want Jacob Murphy in there as well. Okay, that's good. So, sub 4 is not going to be Estevez. No, Adjani's going to come out. And Byron Bubb is going to get a game left wing. And that's fine. Right, how are we thinking, chat? Oh, you're all talking about Francis Jeffers. Okay, that's fine. Right, okay, so this game, slightly weakened team. The only reg, apart from Belmonte, he's fine. But that is a pretty good team, considering that we can swap out almost all of those players. Actually, I think I might actually play Alonso instead of Caroma, because Caroma has been great recently. So I kind of would like to play him. And also, he's only at 87%, so he can come out. Right, that is a good team. Okay, that's a good team for this game. We should be able to do that. Gonna go control. Oh, NJ, that's interesting. Was just at my local deli and they refused to serve someone because they had no mask on. Patron threw their coffee at the attendant and the cops ended up coming. My God, is that normal in New Jersey? is that reasonable? Like, not reasonable behavior, of course it's not, but is that... Is that unusual behaviour? Is that something that you would kind of expect to see? That sounds pretty out of order on pretty much every count. Okay, here we go. Slightly weakened team. Not really, though. A lot of good players still in there. We've got a very strong squad. Oh, Alonso was offside. But yeah, Rago. Oh, Rago's captain. That's probably a mistake. But Rago, Luis Enrique... Garcia, Bub are four players that probably wouldn't normally play. Oh, last ditch tackles. We still started well. 95% of the ball in the first 3.5 minutes. Come on. This is where it's going to get tough to keep this run of wins going when we need to continually swap the team around. I don't know why we have to watch Garcia put the ball down, but never mind. Oh, Rosso nearly got his head kicked off there. You want to watch that. He will actually kill you. Oh, Fulton from the edge of the box. Yes, I love this pressure. Pressure's excellent. I might leave you guys in charge for a sec while I go out and get some water because my throat's starting to get a bit dry. For real. Oh. Yeah, I'm going to leave you for a sec. I'm just going to grab some water. You look after the team while I'm away. Let's take that camera off. Oh, we've scored. Oh, we've scored. Oh, I'm here in time to see it. Oh, Sosa. Takes several touches. Lovely. Good job. Yep, you guys don't need me. You don't need me at all. Lovely. Yep. Oh, great ball from Fulton. Bernardo looks offside, he is. Shame. Panzer and Venema, they've both got a cross on him, obviously. But some of Venema's crossing is just... It's incomprehensible, is what it is. It's just... It doesn't make any sense that he's such a good crosser. But again, it's like I say, I mean... People ask me what you should do. Like, I get messages all the time on Twitter and... People email me, oh, great ball, Alonso, oh. People email me all the time asking me what players they should sign, what the best attributes are for certain positions. I really think, just sign who you think and then watch them play and see how they do, because there's no reason really for Melvin to be such a good left back. There really isn't. My coaches said he deserved a chance. I gave him a chance and he's just been so good. And there's no reason for it at all. Attributes wise, it makes no sense. So you just got to look. Oh, Bub. Oh, what a save. What an effort from Byron. Last minute call up back into the first team. What an effort. It's another ball in from Panzer. That was another good ball into the back post. On his wrong foot, mind you. Look at the possession. 75% possession. In the first half an hour. Just incredible statistics. Go on, Sosa. Done well. Superb. Yeah, you're right. Yeah, CMTID. Sometimes on FM... A player just has that special something, that hidden, exactly, that hidden attribute that makes him amazing. Oh, that's, you're exactly right, yeah. That's why you've got to just trust your, instincts and trust what you see. If a player's doing fine for you, then just play them. I think the same thing about Byron Bubb, to be honest. I mean, Bubb isn't as productive as my other wingers, which is why he's in the reserves now. Oh, Rosso! Rosso scores again! Our goal-scoring centre-back, the red man, makes it to 6th goal of the season for Rosso. He's easily going to get to double figures, isn't he, at this rate? He loves it near post. Even when the ball doesn't come to him, like here. I mean, one of their defenders picks this up. He just tackles it off him and then just took a deflection, but still. Rosso loves it. Loves it near post. Yeah, it is great. It's really great when you find one. Ah, well done, Panzer. I do really like Panzer. We're just so blessed at left back. I think it's just remarkable how good my two left backs are. Bernardo, Byron. Oh, another great ball in from Bub. Bub is a really good option from reserve, for sure. Oh, Garcia, Rosso's there again. Oh, off the line. Off the line. That is the first time I've ever seen a man on the post actually swing his leg at the ball. It really genuinely is. They usually just stand there like idiots and let the ball bounce off them. Oh dear. Oh, just over the bar. It would have been customary for their first shot on target to go in, but it wasn't on target, so it still might. Excellent stuff. Yeah, exactly, NJ. Man City, Pep, build-up play. We are tiki-taka. We are lower league tiki-taka. Keep it going, boys. How's everybody's fitness? Fine. It's all fine. Germ-ridden. I have a guy on my Corinthian casuals game that scored 14 in 23 from left wing, and his attributes are utterly useless. Yeah. It's amazing how some players do it. It's like the players on this, in that when we were in the lower divisions, even lower than this, the guy that was scored like 28 goals with three for finishing or whatever it was. Just how is it possible that they just manage it? Oh, Sosa. So yeah, when you're signing players, you can sign the best players that you can, but sometimes your coaches recommend a player, like five-star recommendation, who looks absolute mint. Go on, Alonso. Oh. Who looks appalling, but your coaches are like, no, you should sign him. And you think, really? And a lot of the time, I just ignore my coaches when a player doesn't look like he's very good. But sometimes your coaches recommend a player and they've seen the hidden attributes that you can't see, and you should trust them. That's why, oh, Rosso's there again. That's why when a coach says to me, one of your youth players is doing really well in training, he should get a game, I just put them in a lot of the time, because that's why they're training well, because they've got, I don't know what the hidden attributes are. How was that? I thought that was a backwards pass. I don't know what the hidden attributes are. I can't remember because it's been so long since I looked. But yeah, one of them must be good. Oh, Belmonte, what have you done? Oh, Belmonte, my God. Just about scrambled to make up for it. Jesus, just shades of Gilpin there. He really fumbled that. And he doesn't fumble much, to be fair to him. He doesn't fumble much. But that was bad. My heart is still... Sosa? Oh, my heart is still somewhere around here. Rosso, love him. Love him. What a signing he's been. Him and Albrechtsen just quietly shutting teams out at the back. I love them. Okay, Rago's probably going to have to come off. 71%. He's looking pretty ragged. Ragged. Stop him. Good blocks. You know who's also done well is whoever plays in my ball-winning midfielder position. In this game, Fulton, who's coming off. No, tactics. Marveggio and Fulton. Just completely cursed him since he's just had to go off. Oh, I might take... Hang on a minute. Got a bit of tiredness we need to sort out here. Oh, no, we haven't got... Oh, disaster. We haven't got Albrechtsen. Well, Daly will just have to do a job at right back then. And Estevez for Garcia, who's also shagged. Bernardo can just go back into midfield, I think. Or actually, no. Bub. There we go. That's the one. Yeah, because none of them are really ball-winning midfielders. Belmonte isn't Gilps in disguise. He's not. Don't say that, please. Let's not curse the man. Yeah, my two players that are playing as ball-winning midfielders, they're not ball-winning midfielders at all. Both of them, according to my assistant manager, both of them are advanced playmakers attack, but they're just kicking people's heads in. It's defensive midfield. It's brilliant. When we actually sign a defensive midfielder, we're going to be unstoppable. If I actually manage to sign a Mahuva Dam, I really hope that there's a regen that appears in the game whose surname is Mahuve, who's a defensive midfielder. You know I'll sign him immediately. Or if we can ever get... great tackle. If we can ever get N'Golo Kante, you've got to believe I'll be retraining him for his real position. No doubt. Definitely retraining him as a defensive midfielder. Oh, Estevez. Oh, Alonso's going to get that. Oh, Alonso. Should have made it three, but it's surely not going to matter. Yeah, Martin. Yeah, I know. It's incredible to believe, but I have actually signed two good centre-backs and a good goalkeeper. Though, I mean, my goalkeeper is still sketchy, as you've seen. But he's not as sketchy as some of the others. So, I mean, he doesn't have as much to do because my centre-backs, all my defenders, actually, are just really, really solid. Look at that lead. Up to 15 points. Though actually, Geisley have got a game in hand, so they could take it back down to 14. But still, what a lead at the top of the table. All of my goalkeepers are rubbish. At every level, regardless of who I sign. If we carry on with Los Coladeros next season and I put Oliver Kahn in goal, he'll be terrible. 11 months out for Dale Fulton. Oh, that is awful. That is awful. He's done his cruciates. 11 months. What a disaster for the young man. Really is. Oh, it's such a shame. Well, I could release him on a free transfer, but we're not going to do that. We're going to stand by him. We're going to give him the treatment he deserves because he's been excellent for us. That's not good news, is it? Well, I have to find someone else from one of our other teams. Well, we have just signed this kid, Kamil Wiktorski. We've also got Lucas Groen, but he can't really tackle. Who can tackle from my... So Wiktorski has got some potential. Oh, it's reports, isn't it? Yeah, he's potentially... He's at the moment, he looks like he's the best option. Let's have a quick look at my... What do we think, chat? Let me know who you think you'd like to see. Personally, I love the Milosip. I'm a huge fan of the Milosip. There's also Mialbi, but he doesn't feel like a defensive midfielder. Particularly. Yeah, advanced playmaker support. Yeah, he's not... I can't put Mialbi in because he is not a tackling player. Let's have a look at the assistant reports. So we've got... I love the Milosip, personally. I'm a big fan of the Milosip. But he doesn't look like he's got very good potential at all. Wiktorski is clearly the best one. I just don't really want to play him because I kind of want to play one of my own youth players. What do we think, everybody? Patrick Vieira would be nice. You're not wrong. Max, thanks for coming, mate. Thank you for coming. Well, we'll try a couple of people in there, you know. Let's have a quick look. Let's have a look at their attributes. Attributes defensive. So, Wiktorski, the Milosip. What about it's teamwork, physical? I want teamwork and work rate are the ones I like. It's mental. 13-15. Joep Nieuwe. Tackling 3. No way. Yes. Renklebe. Murat Renklebe. Tackling 5. But he is actually a defensive midfielder with lots of aggression. Tempted by Renklebe. Milosip really doesn't have the stats, but I love him. I just really love him. He's my boy. He's coming in. Milosip. Gonna give him a go. He's one of ours. He's actually properly one of ours. So we're gonna give the Milosip a go. See how he gets on. He probably isn't gonna play that much anyway. Because we've got Marveggio. Well, no, Stephen, I wasn't saying that they aren't tacklers. They can tackle. What they aren't is natural ball-winning midfielders. They're all naturally advanced playmakers. It's just that they can tackle, which is why I've got them as my tacklers. I've chosen them purely... Oh, yes, new records. Oh, new records all over the place. I've picked them purely because they can tackle. Not Mialbi. Mialbi is definitely not a defensive midfielder. If you throw a young player in to a tackling midfield role who isn't a tackling midfielder, you're just risking... Not only are you risking conceding loads of goals because you've got nobody actually making tackles, but he'll just get sent off. So you need somebody who can actually tackle. Milosip, while he's not brilliant at tackling, he is actually a ball-winning central midfielder. That is his natural role. So I feel like he could be the man. But he's not going to play in the next game anyway because we've still got Marveggio. Marveggio is probably our best ball-winning midfielder. And he's fine. He's fit. So he'll just play generally. I think what I'll do is I'll play him in the next game because you're right, it is first against second. And then for the next game against Solihull in the league, we'll play a second team. And then in the cup, we'll put all of our first team players back in. That's going to be the way that we play this. Yeah, Big Vic looked like he could do a job. Yeah. And Bub. Yeah, Bub can do it as well. You're right. Bub can do it. If needed. Yeah, we've got plenty of players that can do it if needed. Okay, yeah, I don't care about any of this news. This is the first against second is pretty big. I mean, we've got a nice chunky lead at the top of the table. So, you know, we can absorb results not going our way. But for this game, we should have all of our best players back. But, I mean, I'm not even sure what that really means, because so many players are performing well above the level that they should be. Like, way above. But yeah, Clayplay, you're right. Games are coming thick and fast. We're playing Saturday, Wednesday. It's absolutely rattling through the season. Yeah, it really is. They really are landing on us extremely, extremely heavy. Okay. Here we go. So it's Gainsborough away. Oh, I've got a couple of under 19 internationals. That's fun. Oh, he got mentioned before. Joshua Siafa. He was mentioned in the last reserve game as well. Centre back. I'll have to keep an eye on him. He could be another candidate for the first team. Him and Kellen Daly. We'll see. Right, okay, here we go. So this is a big, big game. So this is where we're going back to all of our first team players. Albrechtsen, Rosso. Panzer played really well last time, but we'll play him in the next game. Young Melvin can play left back. My two centre mids are going to be Busby and... there he is on the bench, Marveggio. That's fine. Then we're going to go... oh my God, I can't find anybody. Ajnani left... Capolino center, Caroma right, stud up front. Then the bench is going to be, let's see, Salif Jow, because he can also play right wing. We're going to go Millership. Oh, actually, no, we're not going to go Millership. We'll go Bub, because he can play center mid, as somebody rightly pointed out. We could do with a left winger on the bench, but we've only... Steve Gustan. Yeah, we got Steve Gustan. And then Sosa. Feel like I'd like to put Steve Gustan back in, to be honest. I don't know. Tough one. Well, no, Steve Gustan can come off the bench, cause them all kinds of problems. His dribbling is lethal. So that's right. Yeah, Venema, Rosso, Albrechtsen, Busby, Chroma. Yeah, this is our best team. This is our best team. We're going to go counter. Are we at home or away? Yeah, we're away. We go counter. Right, lads. Here we go. Top of the table clash. Biggest league game so far. Considering we're this far into the season, Gainsborough must be a challenger because they're right up there with us. 15 games in. Yeah, they are right up there. Drawsden are still hanging around. Guiseley are still hanging around. But, I mean, we just played Alfreton, who are only a few points behind Gainsborough. We just absolutely ripped them to pieces in that last game. Okay. Quick player instructions. Right back. Left back. Team talk. Relax and play your natural game. That seems to have been working recently. Counter. Away to Gainsborough. Come on, boys. Let's do them. Let's get them. Oh, Capolino immediately off injured. Oh, no, he can stay on. That's fine. 69% as well, nice. Classic. Him and the stud down the dog and duck. Lady killers. Love this interplay. Don't love that shot from Caroma, but, you know, early sighter. Did he sprain his wrist shaking hands before the game? Yeah, maybe. Goddard surely took a dive there, it says. But Busby getting booked for it anyway. Great refereeing. Superb. Well done. Very good. I don't like it when players get booked that early. I'm not a fan of it. Right, come on, boys. Oh, Cappuccino was there. He'd made a run wrong side. Oh, Cappuccino, Astudillo, it's an own goal, is it? Yes, it's an own goal. Stunning own goal from Watts. Watts, are you doing? Say his fellow defenders and his goalkeeper. Good question. What he's doing is putting us into the lead in just the ninth minute. Suspicion of offside there against Ajnani, but not given. Need to see what actually happened here. Astudio was just causing a bit of havoc. Oh, Watts just slides it past his own goalkeeper. Superb goal. Great finish. Jason Crowe is ex-Arsenal. Oh, is he? I do recognise the name. Go on, Cap. Oh, no. Cap. Cap is obviously going to have to come off, but that's okay. We'll leave him on for a bit. Oh, that is a great ball in from Ake. It's actually a decent header from Melvin as well. I thought he'd headed it to nowhere, but he just headed it into a bit of space. That's a ball. Oh, no. Need to put it in front of the stud. There you go. That's the one. Oh, he was offside. Great save anyway. Really good save. Yeah, Capolino's not going to recover, is he, from that? I have to take him off in a minute. I think 60. Yeah, he's up to 65. Once he drops under 60, I'll take him off. I really like Capolino, though. Oh, great ball, Ajnani. Stud. Oh, stud makes it two. Lovely finish from the stud man. Great ball through from Ajnani. Oh, all over him. Absolutely all over him. Oh, mate. It's very weird, isn't it? Expecting us to win. Or just watching us win. With relatively little drama, he says. Oh, yeah, there you go. There you go. I should just keep my mouth shut, shouldn't I? Why do I say words? I should just never speak. Not a bad goal. Came from the child's flank. Unfortunately, we have to watch all of this because they've got a player coming back on. Yeah, the child is nowhere to be found. There he is, standing inside the penalty area for some reason. Marveggio sort of gets back, but doesn't do anything to stop the cross. My defenders are all backing off. I mean, it's a good, it's not a bad goal, but my defenders can definitely do better there. Yeah, get Cap off now. He is struggling. Oh, he's actually up to 68%. Oh, the stud's in again. Oh, Caroma puts it wide. Cap is okay. Cap is okay. He's actually one of our better midfielders at the moment, which isn't saying much. And it's also the reason I don't really want to take him straight off. I'm sad to say that the child is getting a little bit toyed with down on our left. Oh, Jesus Christ. Great save from the man. Oh, stud. Oh, that's awful. You know, last game I said that both my centre-backs are amazing, and this game they're playing absolutely terrible. Of course they are. I just... Everything I say curses my players. Oh, Astudillo! Oh, the stud. What a free kick from the stud. Right up into the top bins. Now Capolino's coming off. I know it's practically half-time. But he's really dropped down to 52. That'll do. He'll be fine. The child is getting played with. No, I wouldn't say that. Maybe in the R. Kelly game. Allegedly. Allegedly. If you're just joining the stream, you might want to go back to the start. Oh, Gustan. Ooh, Gustan. On his lefty. I mean, I know he's left-footed, but should have swung his swinger at that. Well... Despite the concession, that was a good half. I'll say keep it up. That should keep him on the level, on the straight and narrow. Yeah, you're right. Hang on. Oh, Ajnani. Oh, great save. Yeah, Clayplay, you're right. Yeah, you're right. I wasn't going to play Venema in these sorts of games, the away games to the big teams, but... He's just been playing well recently, so again, I feel like rewarding him, but he's not as solid as Panzer. I should have known. Oh, it did occur to me before the game that I shouldn't play him, but I decided that he has been playing well. But you're right, yeah. I'll stick to that from now on. Great ball, Rosso. Oh, Chroma's done well. Oh. NJ, best signing you ever made. You mean the stud? Definitely. By a mile. By a mile. No entertainment like the stud, exactly. I still say the child is the new Gareth Bale. Yeah, he could be. He might end up being the new Gareth Bale. Oh dear. Oh, great blocks. Ah, easy. Easy for the man. Okay, how we all. Everyone's looking pretty good. Yeah, Marveggio done well. Get that. Great challenges. Ah, oh, superb. Great defending. Just such calm defending. To not just, you know, randomly. I mean, there was at least one random clearance in there, but, you know, people just making sensible headers. Yeah. We just don't play like a non-league team. We play like Man City. Oh, dear. He said. Immediately. Every time. Why do I talk? He's not going to say it anymore. Good save from the man there. Those of you who are detracting the man. Byron can come in for. Let's put Byron in for Marveggio since he's actually quite important now. We've lost our other defensive midfielder. That looks like a good ball. We'll let the stud stay on. He'll be fine for the time being. All right. Oh no, has anyone looked up the stud in 0102? I don't think. Oh, did somebody. Somebody might have tweeted me a screenshot of the stud in 0102. I don't know. Good question. If anyone's got. Oh! Oh! Aka! Oh, Adjnani's down. Adjnani's down. Jesus. Every game. Adjnani is the new Omar. 100%. He is injured so frequently, I can hardly believe it. Oh, Jesus Christ. Why are you doing this to me? There we go. Oh, and actually, Gustan should be a winger. There we go. Adjnani is very injury prone. It's disappointing because I really love him. He's a really good winger. He gives us he gives other teams so many problems with his he's very direct. Like he's got a 7.7. He's very direct. He's just annoying because he gets injured so much. But him and Omar are basically the same player, CMTID. So if you want Adjnani to go, you've got to want Omar to go as well. So think about that. Oh dear, that's a bit of a loose ball. Oh, Bub's done brilliantly to avoid having his legs cut off with that scything challenge. Gustan, oh, terrible. That was a shot out for a throw-in. Yeah, CMTID, you can't. That you're being a hypocrite if you want Adjnani to go, but you want me to keep Omar because they're the same player. So, they're exactly the same. They're both flying wingers who give defences loads of problems, and they're both incredibly injury prone. They're the same player. So, you can't want one thing and not the other. That's just because you don't like Adjnani for some reason, and I'm not sure why. But, I'm not sure what it is, but you definitely highlighted your dislike for Adjnani before. But he's great. He's very, very good. We have got a lot of good wingers, to be fair. Oh, that's good. That's good if he gets sent off. Not for this game, but taking one of their players off them for a few matches with a suspension. Yes, that's good news. That's good news. Gainsborough have lost a player for a few games. That'll show them. CMTID, you think Adjnani's been found wanting? I don't know what you're watching, honestly. I really don't. He's on a 7.7 in this game. He's been one of our best players. I admit, though, that Alonso, Sebastian, is it Sebastian Alonso? I can't remember. Alonso has been really great. I mean, much better than I expected. Oh, that's a great win, though. Really good win against our biggest rivals so far. Well done, lads. That was a good performance. Yeah, DMACC, you're absolutely right. There you go. DMACC said it much more eloquently than I ever could. Lads, 17 points clear at the top of the table. Guiseley have got a game in hand. But at this moment in time, we are 17 points clear at the top of the Blue Square Bet North. Remarkable. Just sweeping all before us. Gainsborough, I've been there. Gaff, yeah. Okay. Good game. Good win. Ah, the cap. Oh, I thought that said 8 to 10 months. 8 to 10 days. That's okay. He wasn't going to play in the next game anyway, so that's fine. He just gets a nice week off. Oh, I want Jesse Lingard on loan. Give me Jesse Lingard on loan. The truth is, I've already tried to sign Jesse Lingard on loan, which is why he's on my shortlist. Don't go to Colchester. Come to us. We're better than Colchester. Obviously, they're our feeder club. We're the parent club in that situation. It's unrealistic regular loans, isn't it? So yeah, the Colchester players are still on there. Oh, actually, just one Colchester player is. We don't need more players. We're fine. We're doing just fine. We are doing just fine. Let's have a quick look at Adjani's stats this season. 12 games, one goal. Should have more goals, to be honest. That is somewhere where he should be doing better. I mean, in that game, it was only their goalkeeper that stopped him from scoring at least twice. But he should score more goals. But, I mean, if you look at last season, 15 games, 4 goals, 3 assists. He's already got 7 in 12. He's great. He's doing really well. Clayplay, is the Invincibles season on? Yeah, it is at the moment. We've won every game but one, which we drew. And even the one we drew, we look like winning. So yeah, we're absolutely smashing it at the moment. So we'll get through the next two games. We'll get through the league game and then the FA Cup game. And assuming we win the FA Cup game, how do you guys feel about me playing the league games to take us up to the... Because after we've done these next two games, we'll finish the stream, because then it'll be about 3 hours, which is about the right time for me to stop. And remember, I'm going to raid Dr. Benji after this one. So you should all come with me to raid Dr. Benji. So then I'll play a few, shall I, to take us up to the next FA Cup game. We'll do the FA Cup games together. But I mean, seeing as we're just absolutely just smashing our way through the league, I'll take a few out. Amazing Astudio, exactly, Gav. Yeah, as a United fan, Jesse Lingard is one of the worst players I've ever seen in a United shirt. Well, let's try and put him in an AFC Ruston shirt. Maybe it'll make a difference. Okay. Oh, Manfred Stark is in the Namibia squad. Manfred, he's got the quality. He's got the goods. Oh, a lot of games being played today. Sunday the 10th of November, massive day for football, obviously, all around the world. Yeah, Lingard, I don't know. I don't watch enough football to have an opinion on footballers anymore, but Lingard for England has looked really good occasionally. But yeah, I think he just flatters to deceive. He should be much better, shouldn't he, Lingard? Then he should be more consistent, at least. He occasionally seems to look quite good, and then occasionally just goes missing for entire games. But like I said, I don't watch enough football to be able to say. I just watch highlights of games nowadays. I very rarely sit through an entire game of football. And for the last, you know, nearly, well, 9-10 months now, I've been living in Spain. I've hardly watched any of English football. I've been watching Spanish. So yeah, I don't really know. Oh, they're back in. That's nice. Yeah, when you don't live in Blighty, you do kind of lose track of the footy. Yeah. Oh, Jesse. Boo. I mean, he's not that great. He'd be amazing for us, of course, but he's not actually that great. I mean, that's probably about right for Jesse Lingard now, isn't it? But he is only 20 on this. He's got plenty of time. Plenty of time. I wonder what Justin Gyorsalin is up to on this, or however you say his name. He's a local lad. He must be about 30, or maybe he's not even 30. I wonder what he's up to. Found his level, Gaff, yeah. Exactly. US football is like watching League Two, though, yeah. Nope. McGinn. John McGinn. Love John McGinn in real life. He's been in my fantasy team all season. Superb. Yeah, we'll get him on the shortlist. Good suggestion. Oh, the stud. Oh, yes. He'll be drinking an extra bottle of champagne tonight. So, one more than the usual 16. Just that 17th bottle is the sweetest. I just imagine that he has had a bubble bath installed in the corner of the Dog and Duck. So you go in, you've got the bar, dartboard, pool table, and then just in the far corner, there's just a jacuzzi with the stud, naked, obviously. He doesn't wear swimming costumes. He's naked in the hot tub with at least four beautiful glamour models from Kettering. Just all the time, just full time. That's what I imagine. MLS is ping pong esque, says Starry. Yeah, I went to Tam and I said in a previous. A massive chain. Yeah, Tim, massive, massive chain. Yeah, definitely. I remember we went not. I said in the previous stream, Tam and I went to see New York City FC against Seattle Sounders in New York. And we only went because I really wanted to see Andrea Pirlo play and he didn't come off the bench, and I'm still bitter about it. The game was so bad. The quality was really, really bad. I remember more than once the Seattle Sounders goalkeeper rolled the ball out to the right back. I don't know who they were. I don't know what their names were. But I saw it happen more than once in the first half. The New York City FC right back. Wow. John McGinn actually wouldn't be one of our best players, but he would be. Their right back ran from the right back position with the ball all the way to the other team's penalty area, unchallenged. And it happened more than once in the first half. And people in the crowd are just chatting to each other, eating hot dogs, not even watching the game. I was screaming, and people around were looking at me. I was screaming because we were sort of technically supporting Seattle Sounders because that's where Tam was living at the time. Even though she's from New York, but she's more of a Sounders fan. I was screaming at somebody to tackle this guy. And people were looking at me like I had something wrong with me. No, no, no. No, no, no. If I'm watching a game of football live and a right back has just run 80 yards unchallenged and crossed into the box. And they scored one as well. They scored from one of them. I was beside myself. Right, okay. Jacob Murphy's going to have a go. Left wing. Luis Enrique is going to come back into defence for Rosso this time. Why not? The child can play in this game. And then Panzer can play in the next game, which is the away game, which is going to be tougher because that's the way around we should do it. Who else is coming out? Ake can come out and... Oh dear, where's Salif Jow? Oh, he's on the bench. Salif Jow can go in. Bub can come in. Gustan can go center. Where's Rosa? No, where's Alonso? There he is. Alonso can come in on the right. Sosa up front. Bernardo on the bench. Busby has to come out. Busby for Garcia, I think. That's pretty good. Albrechtsen, Jao. Yep, Millership, Garcia, Gustan, Murphy, Alonso. We'll have. Need to put somebody on the bench as well, not Ake. Put Panzer on the bench. Maybe I should have this Kellen. Maybe I should have him on the bench. Tim, that is Murphy of Norwich fame. It's true. It's true. Yeah. Yeah, CM Tid. They're so polite. My missus gets mad at me for being vocal. Yeah. You can't get excited at an MLS game. It's really frustrating. Yeah, I get lots of looks from people whenever I've been to a few MLS games with Tam. I've seen Seattle Sounders 4 times, mostly in Seattle, but then there was that one that we watched in New York. And it was, Gustan's only at 92%. We'll put Bernardo in, actually. That'll do. That's a good team, right? Let's do it. Yeah, when you get animated, you get people like turning around and looking at you at stuff. It's like, why are you here if you're not going to get into it? Your team are appalling. Oh, Carl Broadhurst they've got. Ah, former Bournemouth stalwart. Bournemouth mainstay, Carl Broadhurst. Whoops. Well. Yeah, it's frustrating. It's frustrating, and it's also frustrating because the quality is so terrible that you want to get animated. I don't even support the teams, but it still annoys me. It annoys me so much. Okay. We'll see how Murphy gets on. I'll play him as a winger. We'll see how Murphy gets on. Left back. Murphy hasn't got a lot about him at the moment. This is what he looks like. He really hasn't got a lot about him. He's not that fast. He's reasonably strong. Decent dribbler, decent crossing, but still very much a child. I wonder if we can do player instructions to tell him to be incredibly direct. Run with ball often. Yeah, cross from mixed. Cross aim centre. Yeah, that's fine. Right, okay, lads. Here we go. It's a warm-up for the FA Cup first round. AFC Rushden against Solihull Moors. They're in immediately. He's offside. Great start. I haven't looked for Jordan Ibe. Jordan Ibe must have been about 12 at this point, mustn't he? Oh, Bernardo. Oh, great save. Oh yeah, Makeda. Makeda might be. I mean, we wouldn't get him if he's at United. He'll never. You know, we're not going to get any Premier League players on loan. That much has been proven. But you know, we can start looking for players because potentially next season we might be able to get some Premier League players on loan. I think we probably need to be professional before we've got any chance of Premier League players coming. Oh, that's nearly a good ball, but he was offside. I'll have a look for. They got Greg Rutherford, the triple jumper. Who did? Who did? I missed that. Oh, Ibe is the same gauge as McGinn. That's good. Oh, Murphy's done quite well there. Basically, whenever he runs with the ball and doesn't immediately get tackled, I'm going to be impressed. Same with Milicic. It's a good start. Oh, Sosa. Ooh, Sosa. Getting his sighters in. Finding his range. Oh, Greg Rutherford, the triple jumper at Solihull. Sorry, I didn't see that. I missed it. Oh, there he is. Yep, there he is. He's ginger as well. It totally is him. Great challenge from a child. Come on, Millership. Oh, he's not done very well there. Oh, good blocks. Oh, dear. Complete chaos at the back, but it's okay. They haven't scored, which is the only thing that matters. Oh, my God, Garcia. Oh, Jesus, we're 1-0 down. I thought Garcia had given a penalty away. I was too busy concentrating on that. That was a really good finish. See that again. Oh, we'll have to watch them all retake their positions. Oh, no, we don't. Okay, let's have a quick look at that again. I honestly thought Garcia was getting a red card and they were getting a pen here because that is a wild challenge. But, I mean, is that Albrechtsen? What are you doing? It's a good finish. Albrechtsen should be cutting that out. Albrechtsen should be stopping that. It's not a good start. Well, I mean, that's not a good goal to concede. We'll crank it up to attacking. Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, good save, the man. We're not getting champed. They're playing better than us at the moment. Oh, that was always going wide. Did they just have an injury? Didn't see. Oh yeah, they have. Yeah, someone's gone. Oh, Alonso's in. Alonso hit the target. Oh, do something. Oh, that's okay. That looks like an own goal. Yeah, Greg Rutherford scores an own goal. Suspicions of offside. What, against you? He's not a footballer, is he, though? He's a triple jumper. He doesn't know what he's doing. It's not really his fault. He's been thrust into an environment he doesn't understand. There's no way Alonso's offside. No chance. And nobody else can be offside because he's cut the ball back. Yeah, Rutherford just doesn't know the rules of football. It's fair, you know. Come on, we need to build on this now because we've been crap. Now we need to build on this now, I said. This is one of those games where they seem to have an extra player. You know, it feels like they've got an extra man, which is a bit confusing. I don't really understand why. We've obviously got a weakened team. That's a great ball. Sosa's in. Sosa takes a great first touch. Oh, it's going to be an own goal. Oh, Singh saves it on the line. Oh, so nearly an excellent own goal. Okay, we finished the half a bit better. But that was not a good first half. And I'm going to tell him so. Sosa seems down and pressured. You're having a terrible game. I'll tell him I have faith in him. Right, he's not listening. Well, fine. Sosa's probably coming off in that case. Great ball. Oh, Sosa. Oh, that's okay. Murphy's in. Oh, Murphy. Couldn't quite pull the trigger. We're doing a little bit better now. We started really well. First 10 minutes, we started well, and then we just sort of stopped playing football for a while. Oh, where's my player ratings gone? There we go. Yeah, Alonso and Sosa are not playing very well. They're the two main forward culprits at the moment. Millership and Murphy are actually doing pretty well, considering. But yeah, we've got a severely weakened team for this game, so it's not too bad. It's not too bad. Murphy, Garcia, Millership. I mean, Garcia's okay, but Garcia's good when he's got really good players around him. Oh, Jesus Christ. Garcia is usually playing next to Fulton or Marveggio, so he's got a little bit more next to him. But Millership is doing okay, but... Garcia is on a 7, to be fair, actually. I should probably shut my mouth. He's doing okay. Great ball in. Oh, Alonso! Great ball in from Murphy. Superb ball. Alonso finally makes something count. Alonso went... I think recently he's not quite been... He started the season brilliantly. And recently he's not been quite as brilliant. I remember he's missed the target a few times with chances that he really should have at least hit the target. That's still not a very good effort, to be honest. But the keeper's not stopped it. Bosh. I did just say Alonso was playing badly. Yeah, yeah. Whatever I say, the opposite happens. So there's no way we're going to win this game 4-1. No! Oh! Garcia, I was also just saying that Garcia's not that good either. Oh, it's all working out like a charm. See, it's my chat on the touchline. They can all hear. They all know what I'm saying. Okay, very good. Very good. I would say I take it all back, but I don't. Albrechtsen's off. Zhao, you're not captain. Tell you what. Astudillo can come on for Sosa. Studs captain, there we go. And... Bub. Gustan for Bernardo. There we go. Yeah. Oh, Millership's in the book. Good. Oh, we've just won. Blimey, that really skipped past. Oh, well. I was trying to make my substitutions, but it turns out we've just won. So we'll take that 3-1 win. Very good. That really skipped by, didn't it? The last, like, however long. Oh, well, no matter. No matter. Alonso says Mike's half-time team. Yeah, exactly. Yep. Yep, I live in the Matrix, I do. I live in, Only for Champ Manager and Football Manager. I am in the Matrix. I am part of the game. I am the game. Okay, very good. Garcia on form. Just as I was saying, I didn't think he had that much about him. Bosh. Phylum would be delighted. I don't know if Phylum's in the chat. Phylum likes Garcia. He's been good, to be fair. When we signed him, I thought he was going to be a wonder kid. And then Busby just completely put him to shame, because Busby is clearly a wonder kid, like a real one. But Garcia did really well in that last game. I take it all back. Very good. Yeah, DMAC, now they've got to take on our first team. Exactly. But at their place. So the magic of the cup is in effect. Yeah, players know we aren't drinking today, so taking it easy. Yeah, that's right. I mean, it's still been a pretty crushing day of wins, but yeah, it has been a bit different. These have been our games today. So yeah, it has been 2 or 3 goals a game. Still been pretty devastating. But yeah, there's been no Chorley games. There's been no 7-0s. There's still time though. Oh, Jamie McCormack. Is that centre back? Okay, I'll let you go out on loan if you're going to moan. I'll let you go out on loan. Yep. If you're going to moan, you're out. There's offer to clubs. Loan. Yeah, oh, can be recalled, can play in cup matches. Will anybody pay some of his wages? Oh, he's only on 50. Oh, whatever, we'll see if anybody will pay it. Why not? Berry can have him now, Berry Town. He can go there now. I just wasn't letting him go there before we played him. 14 on the bounce, CM Tid, exactly. This is nearly making up for the lost Caladeros heartbreak. Oh, Martin. Don't. I'm going to be sad about it for a while, lost Caladeros. But, you know, maybe having a go at it with Zidane and Stam. Maybe that'll do it. I don't know. This was the season that I really wanted to do it. I really wanted to do it this season. Mark Kurz, yeah, he's sort of done us a bit, hasn't he? Right, Solihull Moors again. But a completely different team this time. They're facing a totally different side. Germ-ridden, you bastard. I'd almost forgotten about it, yeah. I'm pretty disappointed with Kerr. He certainly isn't one of our better, like our best penalty takers, but he's definitely in the top five, which is why I've got had him in there. I deliberately didn't have him taking the crucial penalty because that would have been really heartbreaking. Like the fifth penalty, I mean. But, yeah, I really thought that he would score. And there was one player for Barcelona. Oh, when Thuram stepped up. Thuram, and they've also got a German central midfielder whose name I can't remember, but defensive midfielder. When him and Thuram stepped up, I thought, they've surely got to miss. Vulgaris has definitely got to save one, hasn't he? Nah, none of it. You're just not getting that kind of luck against Barcelona. It will always go their way. Oh, Ramelow, that's right, DMAC, yeah. Carsten Ramelow. I was sure that either him or Thuram would miss. Yeah, even after Kerr missed, I thought we would still go to sudden death. I still thought they would miss one at least, but nah. You're not getting that sort of luck against Barcelona. They will get all the luck. It's actually amazing we didn't win it in normal time or extra time. Those chances that Luque had, that Buffon saved, were... I mean, in other games, at least one of them goes in. Buffon is not human. He really just is not human, that guy, on that game. He's far too good. Barcelona should not be allowed to sign him. It should be banned. Right, okay. Panzer, everyone's coming back in. Now they're going to see Busby... Marveggio, completely different team. Caroma, Capolina. Ah, Cap's still out injured. Well, Gustan, Adnani, and Astudillo. Look at that. What a team. Alonso. Alonso can come onto the bench because Bernardo's not really fit enough. Rago's quite high percentagely. Oh, we've, yeah, seven subs, yeah. In that case, Millership and Daly can both go on the bench too. So that's covered defence, defensive midfield, attacking midfield. Yeah, yeah, that's it. Oh, yeah, seven. Yeah, Clay play. Thank you. Yeah, thank you. Buffon is a bastard, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, well, Martin, Khan, Tobros, and Stam. That's good. Can you imagine a dust up between those three? Gala 11. Don't know what that means. Gaff, sorry. Adnani to score first. Yeah, CMTID. Adnani will get a hat trick now. Just for you. Just for you. Right. That's good. That's such a good team. That's our best team, pretty much, I think. I mean, arguable that, you know, maybe Cappuccino is better than Gustan central midfield. But I don't know. I mean, I'm not sure. Right, this is a really mega game. Come on. The second round of the FA Cup is at stake. Assertive. Show me what you can do. Oh, a couple of them are finally becoming interested. They're finally becoming motivated by me. At last. Okay. Right back. Koroma left back. This is going to be our last game of the day. Because it's the biggest one. First round of the FA Cup. First ever season in the FA Cup. Come on, boys. Let's do it. We've just beaten them. We must have some kind of an advantage over them. Psychologically. Oh, the stud is giving them the runaround early. Oh, the stud off the post, but he's finished it at the second attempt. 2 minutes on the clock. The stud makes it 1-0. What a goal from the stud. What a goal. He plays a 1-2 off the post and finishes it the second time. Total showboat from the stud. Line up those Jaeger bombs in the dugout. Look at that. Bosh, just plays it back to himself off the post. Calmly tucks it away second time. Let's have a look at their team. Let's see, they must be tired. Oh yeah, look, that defender's down at 72%. Oh, Busby, oh, just wide. Actually, it looks like they've done the same as us, you know. It looks like they played their reserve team for the last game. It's that Hinshelwood, Broadhurst. They're the only players whose names I recognise from the last game. So they've kind of done the same as us. But our strongest team is much better than theirs. Oh, Omar nearly makes it two. Oh, Gala 11 is the Spanish for first choice. Oh, I didn't know that. Good knowledge, Gaff. Special day. Yes, the stud definitely gets a statue. A whole wing of the Hall of Fame is going to be dedicated to the stud. We'll have just a gold-plated... Oh, hang on a minute. There he is again. Oh! We'll have a gold-plated jacuzzi out the front of the stadium. The new stadium. Is that the Rodrigo Astudillo public baths? Just down the road in Wellingborough. Great header away from Ake. Superb defending. Oh, Adnani. Oh, but Koroma's going to get there. Oh, he's offside. Disappointing. You need a large bronze bulge in the pants. Yeah, the stud is 100% getting a statue, isn't he? There's no question. Oh, yes. Come on, boys. Keep it up. Oh, that was a header. I was going to say that was a bit of a weird header from Albrechtsen, but he actually didn't win the header that time. Oh, no, that's a really bad ball. Get him. Oh, Belmonte. Oh, actually, that Modest, he might have played in the last game. That striker, Modest. That was a really terrible ball from the Panzer. Not happy about corners. Get rid of that. Oh, Ake. Lovely. Does the stud want it? Of course he does. Oh, and Busby as well. They all want it. Take him out. Ooh, Belmonte. Good hands. Come on. I want to win this game more than any game we've had this season. Come on, stud. Give him a hard time. Shame. Oh, Busby. Oh, I thought he'd got there. Unlucky. Actually, a reasonable crowd for this game. Usually when we play away games, there's about 16 people in the crowd, of which 14 of them are ultras. Well, they've got a player whose name is Classy. Al Brexton's having a bit of a shocker recently. What a save from Belmonte. What a flying save. Tipped onto the post. World-class save from Belmonte. Go on, Omar. Nice. Omar is off. There is no stopping him once he gets started. No stopping him. Panzer's done well there. Not. Come on, lads. Oh, that's a great ball. Oh, Gustan, so close to getting there. Adnani. Oh, into the stud. Oh, the stud's injured. Oh, is he going to have to come off? No, he's okay for now. He's okay just for now. Try and keep him till half time. I don't really want to take the stud off if he doesn't have to come off. He'll be all right just for now. Oh, look at this passing. Great ball. Omar. Oh, Omar hits it across the goalkeeper and into the far corner. Omar makes it two. Come on, boys. FA Cup second round. Here we come. Four clear-cut chances in 14 minutes. I didn't see that. And that one isn't even a clear-cut chance, apparently. Maybe because he's wide. What a finish, Omar, across the keeper. Martin, the stud's complaining of a groin strain. Female masseuse is lining up. And male. Oh, the stud, there he is. That's three. His groin's just fine. 3-0 diamonds. Stud on a hat trick. Hopefully he can get his hat trick before half time so I can take him off at half time. Let's just see that again. Astudillo, Gustan. There's just acres in their defence. Astudillo slides in. Great assist from Omar. Lovely. Oh dear, he could sail a battleship through the Solihull Moors defence. Stud! Oh, unlucky. Yeah, fantastic goal. All, I mean, all of those goals are great. Somebody else is injured. It's Gustan. It's okay. 3-0 is a good lead. Good, comfortable lead. Oh, dear. That wasn't very good, though. Come out. Come out. Come out. Oh, Jesus. No. No. Oh, okay. Phew. Phew. Whew. Oh, Al Brexton's up to 6.9. Thank God. He was down at 6.4. And I just... When my defenders go down like that for no real reason, I just worry that they're about to just sack it. Oh, that was a good block. That was a good tackle from the stud. Stud is the non-league Van Nistelrooy. Exactly. Oh, CM Ted, I'll crack a beer for the stud hat-trick. Me too. Why not? I'll get a Jack and Coke. We've still got some Jack Daniels left. I'll take a Jack and Coke for a stud hat-trick. We are cruising. Well, I'll leave the stud on to see if he can get his hat-trick. Just for a bit. I don't really want to risk him. Injured but feels he can shake it off. Yeah, that's fine. He's okay. We're generally doing great. We're playing on the counter. It's working like an absolute treat. We're just tearing them to pieces. Stud signaling to the bench that he wants pulled off. As soon as we get back to the Dog and Duck, he can spend a week in the hot tub with his ladies. Oh, lovely. Oh, Penner, thank you, mate. Great stream and what management. I know. What can I say? It's going pretty well, isn't it? It's going pretty well. We had a shaky first couple of seasons, but it's all come together in time for this season. The hard work was done last season, signing some really good players. This season, we just had to sort of sprinkle the squad. Sprinkle with some extras. Oh, hang on a minute. They're in the box. Oh, that was a good finish. That was a good goal. Well, we're limiting Solihull to scoring extremely good goals. Because that was a really good goal. He's just got no angle there. He's got to put it right in the bottom corner. It's a good goal. Oh! The stud wanted it. He wanted it so badly. I really don't want to take him off. I want him to get his hat trick. But I also don't want him to get injured for another 3 months. This is standard length of time that he's out injured. No, no, no. Oh, Belmonte, good save. Not that happy about how they're coming back into this. We're going to go control. Maybe we're sitting a bit too deep now. It's worked so far, but now they've had more chances in this half. Well, they've had more chances in 10 minutes than they had in the whole first half. Get that away. Get that away, Marveggio. No, get it away. Why is no one tackling him? Jesus, the defending is a bit desperate all of a sudden. Marveggio, get it away. Away from our goal. Away. That's okay. Another corner. Jesus Christ. What is going on? Solihull. Well, I'll tell you what's going on. Solihull are just having their little spell. Everybody has a little spell. Oh, I've opened beers anyway. Okay, fine. I'll take him off in a minute. We'll wait till it goes grey again. We'll wait till the end of this highlight and then we'll take him off. Okay, ball's out. Sosa on. Oh no, that's Alonso. Whoops. Sosa on. Gustan for Bub. Why not? That's okay for now. That'll do. Oh, Omar's obviously injured. Down to 47%. Classic. Busby's in the book. Another textbook encounter. Yeah, we'll take Omar off before he gets crocked again. Come on, lads. 72 minutes. Let's just see this one out. No more drama, please. No more cut magic, as somebody said in the chat. Oh, that's a lovely ball. Sosa's in the channels. Sosa's in the box. Busby hit that. Oh, that looked like a foul to me. Not given. Okay, we're a little bit stretched here. We're a little bit stretched. Oh, that's lovely. Good defending again. Shit ball from Busby. Absolutely dreadful. Yeah, that's good. That's fine. That's fine. It's okay. It's not amazing, but it's okay. Omar's statue will be made of glass. Yes, exactly. Maybe only just have one leg. The other one's just around the other side of the stadium. Good tackle. Oh, ref, come on now. Jesus. Whenever the ball goes near my goalkeeper, I just expect him to fall over and let the goal in. Just do a Tim Flowers. Lean down to get the ball and it just bounces off a bubble and goes in. Oh, Alonso. Oh, it's gone in. It's an own goal. That'll do. That'll make it safe. Very nice. Let's have a look at the chat. I used to work with a non-exec director of Newcastle United many years ago. We once discussed Duncan Ferguson. Constantly out with a groin injury. It's frustrating, he told me. Mind you, I've met his wife. Very nice. Second round of the cup, lads. It's happening. It's happening. Oh, he said as they immediately score. It's still happening. I don't care what they do. I don't care if they score a second goal in the 88th minute. You can score a header. I don't care. Ref. Oh, no. Let's let us score a fifth. Rosso! Must be! Oh, Rosso. How has he missed? How has he missed? Pretty much an open goal. Sacked it. Oh, well. Come on, ref. Jesus. This has been the longest second half in human history. It's been about 3 hours long. I've actually got a new... I've got a new... For anybody that subscribes far too much money to me, there's a new... I've got a bourbon and milk emoji, which you'll all see in the chat. So anybody that feels like really going mad and subscribing for level tier 3 or whatever it is, you get the bourbon and milk emoji. That's right. Lads, to be honest, they scored 2 goals somehow, but we are into the second round of the FA Cup. Let's see who we're going to get. We'll just keep playing it until we find out who we're going to get. Second round of the cup. Yep, you're quite right. We've done it. I want to see who we've got, and then we'll call it a day. I'm really excited to see who we get. Look at that, nearly 20 grand. Oh, the coffers are swelling. I'm single-handedly keeping this club afloat right now. No thanks to the new board. Superb. Oh, yes. Another chance to draw Scunthorpe. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, Stephen, yeah. All right, here we go. Oh, Aldershot. Oh, Aldershot beat Watford. Wow, good stuff. Martin, oh, you're welcome, mate. Yeah, thank you very much. Yep, same time tomorrow. Same time tomorrow, 1 o'clock UK time. Oh, if we get, I really hope we don't get Brentford or Aldershot. I really don't want either of them. Right, here we go, lads. FA Cup second round draw. There's only 40 teams in it. Okay. Ooh. Walsall away is exactly the sort of game that we'd get. A League One team that we don't want to play away. Oh, Barnet. Barnet's another one. Leighton Orient. Oh, there's Scunthorpe are still in it for now. For now, but we're not playing them. Accrington Stanley. Nope. Or our parent club, Colchester. Not us. Rotherham, one of my champ manager clubs. Nope. Port Vale. Nope. Oh, Aldershot. Oh, please don't be us. Oh, Doncaster. Another League One team they've got to overcome. Dover, Braintree. Oh, we're at home. Oh, my God. Everybody, hold on to your pants. We're going to go draw all teams for this. Still some big names in there. Nottingham Forest, Portsmouth. Actually, I'm just going to draw next team. Oh, it's York. Blue Square Prem. York. Oh, we could beat them, couldn't we? We could beat York. So there we go. Let's have a look and see where they are in the Blue Square Premier. York City. They are 8th in the Blue Square Premier. So it's going to be a test. It's a good test, actually. It's good to just step up one division and see how we'd get on. AFC Rushden, second round of the FA Cup. Oh, my God, they've got Gary Mills as their manager. No way. Oh, it's not. Is it not the Gary Mills? I don't think it's the one that played for Rushden and Diamonds. It can't be because it would be on here. I thought it was former Rushden and Diamonds central midfielder Gary Mills. If it is, let me know in the chat. But yeah, I'm really glad actually that we got a Blue Square Bet Premier team, because I really want to see how we get on against the team who are just in the league above us, because we're going to be up there next season. So it's a good test. I'm glad we haven't got a League One team, because if we can get past York City, and it's not impossible considering how we've started this season, if we can get past York, the FA Cup third round is yawning in front of us. CMTed by their players, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Fergie will be shitting his pants about possibly drawing the Diamonds in the third round. Yep. Oh, there's two Gary Millses, is there? Okay. Yeah, they are playing well at the moment, York. Let's have a look at their recent results. Fixtures. Yeah, they are on the back of a good run. A very good run. Yeah, well, actually, I mean, if you look at their unbeaten run, it's almost as good as ours. Very impressive. Okay. Oh, let's have a look. How are we not? We weren't in their fixtures, were we? Where are we? 7th of December. Let's have a look at where it is in our fixtures. So when I go offline tonight, it's weird it hasn't got, oh, maybe they, I'll just hit continue. They'll have to rearrange one of our games, I guess, so it can go in there. Yeah, rearranged. There we go. So when I go offline tonight, I'll play these three games to take us up to the York game. How about that? What does everybody think? Or do you want to watch the FA Trophy third qualifying round game against Leighton? I realise it's the big one. And if you don't want to miss it, then I won't play it. But I feel like I should just play those three and just get us to the FA Cup. Because, yeah, sounds good. Definitely, yeah. I think so. The FA Cup, clearly we're running away with the Blue Square North. Look at the results. Look at the results. We're running away with the league. So we'll take it up to the Cup game for tomorrow. The league already looked, to be honest, we're nearly halfway through the season. It already looks like a foregone conclusion. I can't see anybody catching us now, quite honestly. We're 21 points inside the promotion places. It's pretty ridiculous. Then Cup and then smash Eastwood because they're rubbish at RVX. Yep, you're exactly right. Okay, lads, right, brilliant. Well, what a great... Another brilliant set of results. I'll take us up to the York City game. I'll see you tomorrow, 1 o'clock UK time, 2 o'clock Central European time, for the FA Cup second round game against York City. And if we can get past them, the FA Cup third round. Oh, can you even believe it? I'm so excited at the prospect. Don't fuck up the league overnight. Thanks, Stephen, for the pep talk. Appreciate it now. Turn the cheat code off now. No, when you're not watching, I'll definitely have it on. Right, lads. Cheers for today. Thanks for joining me again. See you tomorrow. Oh, hang on. Before you go, I was going to try and raid... I want to do a raid. I want to raid Dr. Benji FM. So if you guys are going to stick around on Twitch, I want to raid Dr. Benji because one day I would like to see if he might raid me one day. Because he's really, really popular, a really great streamer, and I'd love to have him raid my channel because then I'd actually get some views, like some proper views. We could expand the ultras to, you know, maybe into the triple figures. Who knows? So I'm going to do a quick raid for anybody that's sticking around. I don't actually know how you do it. I've got to load up this thing here. See if I can get it to work. Let's go. Ray channel. Here we go. I've hit start raid. Okay, let's do it. Six. I've got a countdown. I don't know if you guys can see the countdown. 3, 2, 1... Let's go. Everybody say that you came from Mike Paul Vox and when you get there. Raid now. Let's do it. We're off. We have done it, I think. Come on, load.